Hello, compas, my old friend. I've come to chill with you again. Cause la mija softly sleeping. I just finished all the housekeeping. And the peda that I envision in my brain still remain. El cotorreo is timeless. En estas pedas we'll walk home. Some were drunk and some were stoned. Some taquero under a street lamp. Some were hungry, some cold and damp. When our eyes were blinded by the flash of the neon light, made our night. La taquiza was timeless. We were waiting when I saw 10 narquillos, maybe more, talking masa while they speaking. People and their kids listening.
Face me.
He wasn't sold.
He's giving me that look como que he's very disappointed. Like, ¿pa que le dimos como unas 20 veces, güey? Before you got here.
So esa sí estuvo practicada.
Well, it's because this fucking rola has got some weird ins and outs, güey. But
that was pretty good one.
Either way, oh, welcome back to another episode of Chicano Shuffle. This is Ramon.
Steves.
Fernando.
No me ves así, güey. I really try.
No, yeah, no, you make me a better guitar player, man. Because I have to keep up with your timing, man. Te emocionas, güey.
Just because it picks up, güey.
No, it doesn't pick up, güey. You pick up.
I even told you before we started, no te emociones.
It's not the same as you singing in the shower, güey, where you can, the timing is whatever you feel like, güey. The chorus, you sing it wherever you want it, güey.
This is in rock band.
I have to follow you, where. It's because I don't. Definitely a better guitar player because of this podcast.
Oh, shit. Keep up with Ramon.
Está chida la rola, güey.
That was a good one.
Ay, güey.
Yeah, wait, wait.
It wasn't a chela, it was a cherry coke. Ay, güey. What's that song about, güey? For the people that were too distracted by the timing.
Wow. That's like a hippie song, dude. That's hippie
song. But your chords? Oh, your lyrics?
My lyrics? Well, that one. So.
Sounded like you got into some shit with some narcos, güey.
Narquillos, güey. Narquillos.
Oh, narquillos. The younger narcos.
The narcos would have killed them. Yeah.
I got this idea from my sister. She put up a post of someone doing this cover. But it was about el pinche el trompas, güey.
Oh, okay.
Right? And the administration y todo. So I'm like, oh, shit. So I was listening to it.
Talking about plagiarism.
Yeah, right? So then me agarré thinking about it. I'm like, holy shit, I think I could work something with this one. That's when I asked you, hey, do you know about, have you ever heard this song?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know this song? You've heard it?
So yeah. When I started writing right away me acordé de la pinche noche de King Taco, güey. Mm-hmm. Que nos agarramos con, bueno, no nos agarramos, pero.
Yeah.
We cross words.
Yeah, no, there was a discussion.
The night that we went to King Taco con los, y en vez de 10 narquillos eran que dos.
Eran güey.
Eran dos, güey.
It was like 5 of us and it was one guy with a gold chain y es narquillo, güey. What the chivato. Ya no son esas camisetas de silk ones, huh?
I don't know, güey.
Remember those?
They don't use them anymore?
I don't really
see. Son de rayon o de rayon?
Rayon, yeah.
Rayon, the rayon shirts.
Or son silk.
Ese güey la compró en los callejones, güey.
Yeah, it was cotton.
That's why they rayon, güey.
It was cotton. Rayon's pretty good fabric, güey. That's what they use the higher end Hawaiian shirts. They use rayon. But I think those were like silk, no?
Probably.
Or the original ones were silk.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
The cajon one was rayon.
It's probably cotton, güey.
La fayuca, güey.
Yes.
So me agarré. So that song was inspired from that King Taco night.
Yeah, but instead of the narquillo, ¿cuántos dijiste que eran?
Eran 10, no, 10 narquillos.
Era un vato, güey.
Maybe un vato more, güey.
Yeah, one of those gold Casio watches, the ones that the hipsters wear now. Y este güey es un narquillo.
10 narquillos, maybe more.
Okay, I remember he had a Rolex. Now it was a Casio, güey. No mames, that was there.
Casio le faltaba una letra porque también era el cajón.
Era, güey.
It was a Casio.
It was a Casio, güey, with the K.
While we were waiting for Fernie, I'm like, hey, wait, fucking, let's practice it.
Se le quedaron las cobijas pegadas a este güey otra vez.
Yeah, pretty much.
You forgot it was Sunday. Oh, you forgot we recorded today.
Yeah. Must be nice.
Está cabrón,
they gave us a chance to rehearse this awesome. ¿Cómo se llama la rola? Yo ni me.
Se llama El Cotorreo Es Timeless.
By who?
By Ramón en Estebanco.
Estebanco, siéntate, culero.
Estebanco.
Siéntate, pues.
Oh, ¿te gusta el banquito?
Right away, a mí el nombre me lo mamá, lo pone todo madreado y deja Ramón chingón.
Yeah, an underlined, look, bold and underlined.
I know, what the fuck? What the fuck
you
is that?
Right?
No, I didn't notice.
I was staring it up before. I'm like, hey, why is his name fucking bold and underlined?
But it's
he randomly ran out of ink when he was typing my name.
Se le acabó la linita abajo.
I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened, but
I don't know.
The thing is que I copy and paste, right?
Si no es nada sin mí, güey.
Wow. What a dick.
I introduced you to fucking music.
I don't know, güey. We weren't sure if you knew this rola, güey.
I know, right?
I wasn't sure.
It's pretty cool, man.
But yeah, because it's Simon and Garfunkel. So
yeah, for those
Simon,
of you who don't know.
Ramon.
You should have said Simon.
Simon y Garfunkel. Simon Garfunkel.
Pero muy bien que his ass is underlined.
Yeah, I know. I saw that right now, güey.
So, special color para que lo veas.
Este banco.
Este banco, siéntate, güey.
¿Y te gusta el banquito?
El Sarabia, güey.
Ay, el Sarabia, güey.
El Sarabito.
La banquitas.
No, el banquito.
Chief Fernie.
So I was... I was working on this one, and I wanted to not get it right, but I wanted to make it fit in. So,
yeah. ¿Te gusta the writing process or what?
I do. I like thinking about it, and like just thinking as like me imagino, and I'm like, how am I gonna word this? Mm. Porque I was particularly proud when I throw that one with Tapoli, gave us all a warning, and then because his partner was in the line forming.
But you know, does it disappoint you when you show us the song and you're like, when you're writing and you're like, this one's gonna make him laugh, and we're just kind of reading through it, and then we say, oh, está chido, güey.
Puro business.
Inside, do you kind of die a little bit inside?
A little bit. Yeah. I'm like, because I'm like looking at you guys. I'm like, all right, let me see. Oh, this should be at this point. This should laugh.
Yeah.
And you just shake your head like, okay.
Cuando la pones aquí ni la abrimos.
Yeah, I know, right? No, I bet he writes it and he's like, oh, I'm gonna get him with this one. Esta va a estar chingona.
This is my best one yet.
Hey, all I do is lo regaño because of the timing.
La letra está bien, güey. Esta está.
Te salió chida, güey.
Yeah, la letrita está chida.
Right away, está chida. Es de otro pinche mandilón, güey.
Well, because you said, because la mija softly sleeping. Dije, ah, este güey sneaks out.
And I finished with the housekeeping.
Yeah,
well, the thing is.
Well,
that,
you gotta help out también, güey.
Yeah, you know.
Pégate de mamadas. We gotta help out in the house, güey. No sean culeros. Pinches vatos. It's 2018. I almost got into it with a tocada. Do you remember? You were there, puto. Because, you know, I when we go out to play, way, I don't have a fucking roadie that carries my shit, way. I don't have like that staff that's in the band that fucking sets up my gear. I have to carry that shit and put it into the show, way. Y pues esta, my girl, she wants to help me, way. So I let her carry my guitar. It's not even that heavy, way. It's like 8 pounds. Pinche guitarra con la punta la levanta la culera.
Ah, cabrón.
Y so we were leaving.
I don't know why I look at Fernie like, is it true?
Con la punta, I don't know.
And so we were leaving and I had my amp and my pedal board. And then we kind of nos quedamos ahí distracted because we were talking to the crowd. Estaba, some girl was there. Que la trajo el pinche the river, and we were already on our way out, and so she kind of had a little attitude, where she was a little sassy.
La amiga.
Like, yeah, I was like, oh, all right. Y dice, I like how you make her carry your guitar. Me dice,
wow.
Yeah, and I was like, yeah, porque era la amiga de ese güey. No le dije nada, but I thought it was like my own business, cabrona.
We still made fun of Esteban a little bit.
Yeah, they made fun of me, but I was really gonna get into it with her way, but dije, eh. I was kidding. I'll avoid it.
It looked pretty cool.
You know what though? That's
no, like, la sueltes.
That's
no la pongas en el piso sucio.
Es chinga de ser novia de un músico, ¿verdad?
Mm, yeah, it is a chinga.
Es una chinga,
yeah.
Because, you know, ella le toca ayudar. Bueno, no le
well,
toca.
I didn't tell her here. She wants to help.
No le toca, but either way, like, she could just go inside and take a seat and just wait for you while you unload and everything, right?
Yeah.
But she takes it upon herself to help you out.
Yeah, no.
And that's fucking cool, pero si es una chinga dating a musician.
Yeah, because then they feel ignored, güey. Les tienes que hacer caso because you're at a show. Mm-hmm. They think it's like a date. You're like, fuck, I'm working. Like, it's kind of like, yeah,
I'm working.
I have to network. I have to talk to people. I have to make contacts. But unless they feel that you're
abandoning them.
You're abandoning them. And it sucks, güey. I get it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's tough. Yeah, yeah, because I've seen ads or not ads, but like fucking posts like from other como se diría, followers or like just random people que ponen chingaderas. And then I saw one not too long ago and like, you know, when you're dating a musician y pasan a la muchacha with like fucking 10 chingaderas hanging. Yeah. Y el güey con el micrófono.
Yeah.
That's about what it was.
Nah, it's an 8-pound guitar.
I remember once, when was it? Where was it at?
Yeah,
it was,
I thought it's 2018. I thought we were all equal. It's an 8-pound guitar. What are you complaining about? Pero nada, como era la amiga del compa, me quedé callado.
But again, what was it? Like a couple of years ago, you guys played over here by, what was it, Burbank or... Mm. There was a little bar. And I remember que you were carrying your stuff y todo. Y también the bassist, el pinche, the guy with the big fro.
Yeah, John.
John.
Yeah.
The drummer and everybody was carrying their shit. Mm-hmm. And pinche Rivers just shows up with a microphone in his back pocket.
Yeah, sí son esos culeros.
When he had that's when he had his T-Bird. I think he had just gotten it out.
Mm-hmm.
And then de ahí nos pelamos a pistear. And that's when I think...
Oh, we took the wrong way, no?
Yeah, we ended up in fucking City Terrace.
I remember that way.
And then there's a point where like the person that you were with in the car took a picture.
Yeah.
And we're behind. And you see el pinche Rivers and me looking at each other.
Like where are we going?
No, like
like romantico.
No,
I guess at a moment.
Instead of paying attention to the road, we're both talking, looking at each other.
Ay, güey.
No, güey, estábamos un poquito fumigados ese pinche día, güey.
Fumigados, güey, fuck.
Yeah, that was a crazy night.
Yeah, so it was yeah, that happened, güey.
Yeah, that happened.
¿Qué va a ser, güey?
Pero mames.
Yeah. I try to get lighter guitars para que no le duele la espalda.
How much does this case weigh?
Pero nunca quedó bien.
It's because it did look cruel, güey. You're just chilling ahí, pinky, con frío. Y aquí hasta holding la guitar como se le dijo, hey. I better not see a shit on the floor.
Oh, shit.
You're going to carry it.
That would have been funny to be in. No.
It looked weird, but like when he explains it, because it makes sense.
But luego, then I took it from her. I'm like, yeah, you're right, because then she'll probably drop it. Está más cabrón.
You said that? Yeah.
I said that. Ay, güey. Ay, güey. No, pero gente bien, they always have their opinion, güey.
There's some people that like, they like to speak out loud.
Yeah.
They say what they're thinking. They don't read the room. Or maybe they do read it and it's one another. They're just assholes.
Yeah. I thought it was pretty funny.
That was funny.
That was pretty funny. That was funny. It está más cabrón cuando te lo dicen a ti, but when you hear it and you're standing, it's pretty funny.
Like, yeah. Fuck.
I mean,
I know that feeling.
But you know what? Everybody that I've dated has helped me with my shit. It's not just her. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's just, and I don't do it. Hey, you got to help me with my shit. You're getting it for free, cabrona. I don't tell them. I don't have that talk before the gig. Hey, cabrona, you're going to get it for free? You're going to fucking drink for free? So you carry my shit.
Pero vas a trabajar.
Eh? What is this?
Y nada de la pinche guitarra. You're carrying the amp.
Yeah, nada de pinche pedal board. That's the heavy one. Cabrona. I don't say it that way. They just help. But this one, all of a sudden, it's a big deal.
Y quiero los cables bien rollados.
Yeah. En los años, all the years that I played, I've never had anybody comment on it. And then she was the first one. Pinche matiche.
Te voy a llevar con Ramón to show you how to fucking coil up the wires.
I'm going to send you the training to Ramón's garage.
Yeah, right?
That's the way he's particular how he has his wires coiled.
Yeah, you're lucky I don't make you tune my shit and set up my pedals. No, but I mean, it's funny, way. It's just, I mean, I'm a nice guy, way. I don't think I'm an asshole, but I think
it's debatable.
That's what I mean. That's what I mean. That's what I mean. That's exactly what I mean.
Potato, tomato.
That's not what the canción says.
Yeah. Like people, especially in my relationship, I feel like a lot of times people think I'm a dick, but they don't see. They don't know everything that I do.
No,
they don't see the relationship.
Yeah.
But they're quick to comment on,
because
on
it works. It works both ways, because sometimes they'll say like, oh my God, he's such a nice boyfriend. Yeah. Oh, he's such a nice guy. But behind closed doors, he could be an asshole.
Yeah.
You know, he could be, you know, diciendo de chingaderas, maltratándola, fucking chipping away at her soul with fucking negative comments.
Yeah. But some people are just like when we had the Friendsgiving, también, I got a little bit of shit because they were saying that I was making her hang out with me. That she wasn't in.
Oh, la pinche. La
carnada. No, but that's still like people say that. And it's not that I do that. It's just she's very socially awkward. Uh-huh. So it's hard for her to have a conversation with people she doesn't really interact with. Mm-hmm. And I tell her all the time, go talk to them. Pero to people, it looks like I'm like the one that wants her by my side.
Y después le dices, hey, ve a hablar allá, por favor.
Yeah. And then I sound like
that. Yeah, you sound like
sí, nunca quedó bien, güey. And then nunca quedó bien, güey.
Déjame en paz.
Hey, güey, pues déjala. She wants to be right here. What the
she
fuck?
She wants to be with you, güey.
Yeah, but you guys heard it, no? Yeah. Even though it's joking, it's like.
Well, I didn't hear it. I just
They're fucking busting my balls.
It was my sister that was giving them shit, you know?
No, también hasta, it was mostly la ¿Cómo se llama esta cabrona? Yeah, I take notes, güey. ¿Cómo se llama la cabrona?
I'm taking names, puto.
La de curly hair.
Oh, Cristal.
Yeah, it was her, mostly.
Yeah, pues ella le sigue la nina, güey.
Oh, really?
Yeah, fucking. Yeah, le sigue
she's
la
a follower?
She's no,
a,
no, no.
She's a
she
support.
Just, Noelia's the alpha female.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Noelia fucking. Yeah,
she's the alpha.
Yeah. She, there's Parks and Recreation. Have you ever seen that?
I've seen a few episodes. Okay. Yeah.
You know the black girl?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She reminds me of if Noelia was black, that's how I think Noelia would be.
Yeah.
You know, yeah,
las tiene, las regaña las cabronas.
Yeah, las tiene el tiro.
Esa es la de treat yourself.
Yeah, treat yourself. Oh, that was I was rolling with that when I just saw it.
Treat yourself.
That Parks
and Rec. Estos son alfas los dos. Yeah, always try to control the room.
They always underline their name.
I know what the fuck, Ramon. What the fuck, man? She's vatos.
Treat yourself.
She's vatos.
No, baby, but. It was anoche las llevé a ella, a mi carnala y a la esta alarma to Christy Christmas, K-Rock.
Mm.
And shit.
Oh, shit.
They want to go see, they saw Bad Religion.
Oh, yeah?
AFI, pinche Third Eye Blind.
Oh, shit.
¿Quién más? Smashing Pumpkins.
Smashing Pumpkins también.
Yeah, Greta Van Fleet.
That's a good band. They play. They sound like Zeppelin.
Yeah, but I was hearing that Mika was telling me that she was reading that there's a lot of critics talking shit because they're so young. They're not really musicians. They're just kind of adapting different styles from different bands. Like, he looks like a young, the singer looks like a young Bob Dylan.
That's when you're young, that's what you do, no?
Sings a cross between Axl Rose and Robert Plant. And he was dressed up like Jim Morrison. Right? So it's like, yeah, these guys are not original. I'm like, you know what? They're fucking good.
Yeah, no, people, they're always going to talk shit with. But Robert Plant was on the record saying that he gives them his the torch. Because they were saying, ah, these guys are like Zeppelin. They sound just like Zeppelin. They're not original. And I, again, Robert Plant was like, ¿sabes qué, güey? How are you going to pass a torch if you're fucking talking to bands like that? Let them fucking be. I give them my blessing.
If they, yeah, if they sound like Zeppelin, but they're good, pues they're good.
They're really good. The guitar player is really good.
I've never heard them, but I'm saying if they're good, pues
it's like hearing Zeppelin. Yeah. It's like they sound, they have the same.
But yeah, the rhythm and everything. Yeah, but el singer, yeah, his voice, he sounds like a mix, a cross between Axl and fucking Robert Plant.
Yeah. Pero son buenos músicos.
Yeah, dude, I like it. I like their jams. I like
¿Cuáles son? ¿Cómo se llaman estos güeyes?
Greta Van Fleet.
All right, I'll fucking find them.
Greta Van Fleet.
Yeah, you're going to forget that name, güey. No. Mándale el link.
I will.
Just put fucking fake Led Zeppelin.
Greta something.
Google, fake Led Zeppelin.
Le va a salir Greta from fucking Cam Girls.
whoa.
Wrong one.
I know.
Whoa, I didn't put it on private.
I didn't go incognito on this one.
Be careful, brother. Watching us.
No, whoa.
Be careful where you end up with.
That's going to change all my ads right there.
Yeah, once you're on Instagram, te van a tirar los pinches ads like, what the fuck?
Yeah, but what
the other day I bought a jacket on at the thrift store. And I bought the jacket where I was like fucking stoked. Never heard that brand in my life, right? And then I was on Instagram and me salió the fucking the sweater that I bought.
Oh shit.
Through the sponsored ads. I was like, how the fuck do they know?
Did you say the name of it? Well, they're always recording, way.
I know that's what I've heard, way, but I don't know.
Yeah.
But it was kind of trippy, way. Que la compré una pinche segunda vieja, way.
Yeah.
Una pinche segunda toda dusty. And all of a sudden, Instagram tells me, hey, check out these.
Check out a nueva.
Check out the new ones. Yeah.
Maybe one new, way.
Jeez, razas, way.
No way, pero está. It's been a crazy fucking week, way. Well, not crazy, but it's been interesting. Fucking number 42 passed away. El pinche George.
42, 41, way.
41?
41. That's 41? I think it's 41.
41?
We need to look it up because you're looking at me like fucking I'm lying to you.
Because it was ¿Quién era? Era George Bush, luego era Bill Clinton, luego George Bush again.
¿Vas a contar los 40, güey?
Y luego Obama. 42, 43, 44. Oh, yeah, it was 41, you're right. I'm my bad. Number 41 passed away. Everybody's going to freak out like, what?
Yeah.
Bill Clinton passed away?
I know, right?
Number 40.
He makes do this math.
Yeah, number 41 passed away, way, and it was pretty. You know, a lot of people may not agree with.
I saw both sides.
Yeah,
41st
president.
Yeah, 41st. Okay, he was a. You know, they could have their opinions about that president or lo que sea.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end, it shows. It really shows I don't know, the quality or the magnitude of the person, because a lot of people went. I mean, did you see Bob Dole? Ya está todo decrypt.
I didn't even see
ya está morimundo, güey.
Pues que no sé, güey. In his later years, he was skydiving and all this shit.
Hey, fucking living the life.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, he might have been an ass. He might have been terrible. He was the head of the CIA. He was all this shit.
Yeah,
he did a lot of fucking stupid shit. Wait.
Well, the one that I stood out the most was the hostages in Iran, where he met up with them to be released, not under Jimmy Carter.
Mm-hmm.
But he's a president, way. You can't expect a president to be like fucking walking the line, way.
No,
but even before, like you said, he was the head of the CIA. He did some shady shit. He did. He was part of the thing that. Because también me cae gordo because I heard some other things where like people that are like, you know, we have the super left now and the
super right.
Super right. Like the dudes on the super left were like, no sé por qué se hablaran tanto. This dude did all this fucking
evil shit
that fucked up everything. But this is not the time you bring that up. Well, he still did good things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And when someone passes away, you don't want to fucking be throwing out all the bad he did, way. He did good things. Maybe he did the bad for fucking, you don't know the whole story, you know? Yeah. Fucking people just take the end, the tagline and... This is not the time, way. It's just...
But the one thing that stood out for me throughout this whole thing, and I didn't follow it. I just saw things here and there, but there's one that he had a service dog. Mm-hmm. Se llamaba Sully. No mames, güey. Hay una foto donde el perrito está tirado. No está tirado, pero está echado. Mm-hmm. Right by the casket, dude. Mm-hmm. Like still there. It's like, fuck, dude. Like, pinches ojos se me arrasaron. I'm like, we don't deserve dogs.
Yeah.
We don't deserve these animals, dude. They're fucking faithful.
I think
dude.
We do deserve them, because ¿cómo van a comer los culeros? Who's going to take them to the vet, güey?
We already domesticated them.
I know you're trying to be all romantic, but
no,
who's going to feed these fuckers?
A little deep, dude.
When you wake up fucking early, los culeros se quedan en la camita toda chingona. Who's gonna feed them, güey? No mames. They don't deserve them. Van a estar en el pinche lluvia todos fríos los culeros if it wasn't for us.
Yeah. What a dick. Por eso dicen que eres un asshole, güey.
You know how much the vet bills are, cabrón?
I know.
Are they gonna pay for them?
I know. I know gonna pay how much. For them? But you know what? Acá mi security is she's family, güey.
Stella? No, well, es que,
she's
yeah.
She's family.
But, I mean, I get what you're saying, güey, but it's a little... stretch of a comment.
I'm just saying.
we deserve each other, way.
Yeah, but these animals.
I like, see them and I feel like, how can people mistreat them, man?
I know. Like, I can't.
I've heard stories where, like, in Mexico and ¿te acuerdas la chaparrita that I used to date? La esta Marlene. Mm-hmm. Her uncle used to do some crazy ass shit to the pinches gatos, way. Like some psychotic shit. Like, fuck, that's borderline shit. And when you see a little animal like that, you think, how can you hurt this fucking little animal?
I don't, yeah, I don't get it. Sometimes these people are wrong. Maybe están traumados, or están, I don't know, maybe están pinches locos, güey.
Yeah.
And it's just like, I can't, I don't,
yeah.
Even from picking the wild ones to the domesticated ones,
yeah.
I don't even go hunting. I don't care for hunting or fishing for that same reason. I mean, me gustan mis taquitos del pastor y de pinche.
But then see that, then you prefer somebody else to kill your shit.
Yeah,
man.
That's
not.
You don't want to see.
Yeah,
fucking,
that's definitely not the way to think. It's like, in my opinion, that's my opinion.
No, no.
I would rather hunt them than buy them in a fucking in a container.
I totally get you, and it's one of those where like I'm conflicted.
You're not conflicted.
You're
not
conflicted. No.
But see that's also the fucked up part about animals, because there's certain animals that we love as pets, and there's certain animals that we don't mind getting slaughtered to eat.
Yeah.
So what is that, where? You know?
That's deep. That's deep.
I mean.
Hey, pero hablando de eso, then you heard about that thing they're trying to pass, no? The city council that they're gonna, like, in the LAX, they want to mandate. Well, I guess it's like a mandate way. Where that all the restaurants have to have like a vegan option.
Ah, no mames.
In LAX. And then they want, like, it kind of applies to the outside too, but they're trying to like push all the restaurants to like have a vegan option.
Yeah.
On the menu, a huevo, you have to have a vegan option.
Se quejaron los pinches vegans.
But I was like, dick, this, why?
I mean, it's a change of times.
Yeah, like, but one thing is mandate. One thing is to llegar at the restaurant and they keep walking away because they're vegans.
Yeah.
Then obviously the market's going to go, okay, we need some vegan options.
That should be left up to the proprietor.
The establishment,
That should be, that I agree. That should
Llegas
be
a un taquero, hey, wey, ¿por qué? Why don't you have tortas? What the fuck? Yeah, you sign a bill that you have to sell tortas?
Well, not only that, but I mean, if you're vegan, I mean, the whole dynamic changes in the sense of like, your bread no va a ser regular bread, no va a ser virote.
No, pues cuesta ya feria.
No, man. Deja de eso. Lleva huevo, güey.
Yeah. Well, there's substitutes, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So you not only are you going to have this type of bread over here, but then you have to have this other type of bread.
And then you have to learn how to buy the product, because si no viene un pinche vegan for 2 months, se te va a echar a perder el pinche...
For 2 months.
Whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Sneak in that vegan pan for this one.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to be getting random
medio,
vegan
está
pan.
Está medio rancio esta torta.
Así das, la culero.
Échale mayonesa.
Es lo que quiero, güey.
Yeah, I just didn't like that whole idea, güey, that they're trying to... I don't know if... I think it was this way, no sé si pasó o no, güey. I didn't hear about it.
Crazy, güey.
Pero, yeah, that sounds fucking kind of douchey, no?
Yeah.
Fucking now you're telling a business fucking restaurant what they have to serve, güey.
Yeah.
Well, fucking, I know that at least for los taqueros, güey, it shouldn't be a problem.
No.
Because las tortillas, they're gluten-free.
Are they gluten-free?
Yeah. Es puro pinche maíz, güey, y agua.
Sí, es cierto.
No lleva huevo, no lleva nada. All right? Y te puedes echar unos pinches taquitos de chiles toreados o de rajas.
Mm-hmm.
O te puedes echar taquitos de calabaza, güey.
Pues guisados got pretty good options. Yeah. Tienen de pinches, they got the calabacitas.
Yeah.
What else do they have? Tienen de frijolitos.
De frijoles. Yeah. Tienen de también de los chiles toreados. They have the... What else?
They are those chiles organic.
Or the pescatarians también tienen de camarón, de pinche pescado.
Hablando de guisados, fucking last Sunday, la mija and I want to go do the Ciclavia. The Ciclavia in downtown LA.
Yeah.
And we went a little bit late, but
what is that for people that are like in Ciclavia? Fucking Montana? They're wondering what the fuck is Ciclavia?
Oh, I know.
Well, they don't have one.
Or in Kansas City, como el Chapo. Oh, fuck. It's PG. I gotta talk to you about that one. El Chapo. So Ciclavia, they have it over here in
LA. Is that how you say Ciclavia?
Ciclavia. Or Ciclavia or Ciclavia. Oh, I hear people say Ciclavia, but mainly son los güeros, so I don't know. They're just saying they're Ciclavia. But I'm like, a mí lo veo y me sale
Ciclavia.
Ciclavia.
Oh,
all right. So what it is that it's like every 3 months they have an event. They close it down. They close down certain parts of the city, like
streets. It's not
streets.
They don't close down the businesses.
They have traffic control, and they have, you know, certain areas are like the streets are closed. No puedes pasar. But another the main avenues is controlled by the traffic. Police.
Mm-hmm.
Is it traffic?
Sounds about right. Yeah.
That was a long explanation.
I know.
They get
so, they'll shut it down. It's all strategized. It's all fucking. Está chingón.
Yeah.
Se organizan chingón.
Yeah.
So they'll have it's like 8 miles maybe.
And it depends on the little.
Yeah, it depends on the area and it miles. And then along the side, there's like, you know, there's they have stages for events for the kids. They have a fucking bands playing. They'll have a DJ. And then the bars or the restaurants are all open. So se pone chingón el ambiente. And everybody's on their bikes and skateboards. They're walking. They're running. They're rollerblading. Fucking hay unos que veo unos pinches patines with the long. They got the longboards with sticks. Like if
like a paddleboard.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I haven't
seen. Esos cabrones se avientan. Son como unos 10, 15, güey. They're like.
Oh, really?
It's una pinche pandilla, güey.
Oh, shit. That means I need a stick now.
Yeah. So they'll do it in the city. So it's from like maybe 9 to like 4.
Wow.
And so la mija y yo nos aventamos. We went and I took my pinche my Chicano shuffle shirt. Mm-hmm. I to represent.
Yeah.
More fucking represents. Ahí andamos. Y ya como eso las 12 y algo nos dio hambre. So we went to guisados, man.
I can imagine Ramon with a shirt in an event like that. Y no les da la espalda a nadie so they can read it. He walks like.
Oh, I did that. So we end up in Little Tokyo, right? So we park the bikes and we walking around. And then I see that there's two guys interviewing some lady, right? So I'm coming up from behind them. And I see them, and I see that they have the camera. So as soon as I pass them, I turn around. Como que si estoy apuntando para que se vea la camisa, güey. I turn around. I'm like, oh, no, no es para allá. So I keep walking. And then the mija turns around. She looks at me. She's like, I just saw what you did.
Yeah.
I'm like, what? What did I do?
Ramon doesn't miss a moment.
Y haciéndome pendejo. Like, what? What are you talking about? Like, yeah. And she's just shaking her like, yeah, that was not smooth.
Yeah, that's all right.
You're not a smooth. Dude.
Yeah, it's all right. They get the idea.
So, así pasó. So, I'm doing all of vamos a guisados, güey. And we're waiting in line. When all of a sudden, the guy behind the register, he turns around and he looks at me. He's like, Chicano Shuffle, the podcast. Mm. I'm like, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, yeah. Simon, like, Ramon. I'm like, yeah. And then I'm
he's
like
wearing his Dickies shirt.
No, wait, no, it was the t-shirt. I had a sweater underneath with a hoodie, luego me eché la t-shirt encima.
Pues obviamente no te van a confundir por Esteban. Esteban, what the no.
He saw the Chicano Shuffle sweatband, the handball edition.
Handball edition.
El saladito.
Tía, ven para dentro. La tía haciendo las tortillas en el guisado. Ahí viene el saladito. Tía, córrele.
Toma tu break, tía. Toma tu break.
Córrele, tía. Pobre tía, haciendo las tortillas allá en guisados. Y llega Ramón.
Oh, shit.
With this little headband.
So así pasa. He's all like, you know, he does that. And then there was like 2 people in front of me. And I'm all like, fuck. And I turn around at the mija. And I'm all like, fuck, dude, I'm nervous.
Yeah.
So I'm like, what? Why? Like, I got nervous.
You got a little sweat mustache going?
Yeah, me puse nervioso. I wasn't expecting that. I wasn't expecting none of that. So yeah. I'm like,
but you wore the shirt.
Yeah, but.
So you weren't expecting for somebody to
recognize me. I just wanted to get people curious to be like, hey, what's
what
that?
I'm
like, look it up. Mm. You know, it's a podcast.
Look it up. No le va a explicar. That doesn't sound like Ramon.
What an asshole.
That's not Ramon. Oh, this?
Yeah, look it up.
I have a podcast.
Yeah.
I never say yeah, I
started a podcast with two buddies.
No, una vez se le salió. Yeah, I have a we have a podcast.
Oh, I have a podcast. Yeah, yeah. Fuck that.
¿Dónde fue que te salió? ¿Te acuerdas, güey?
Bernie, let's
have a podcast.
That's the way. I'm not showing up for the next 3 weeks. Fuck it,
you're taking this from a guy that forgets that we recorded
that today. Forgets a Sunday. You know? Let's not show up for the next 3 weeks. A ver cómo le va con su podcast. Chiculeo.
Va a ir bien, güey.
Yeah, I got backing tracks on YouTube.
His name is titular, güey.
A ver cómo te va, culero. Chivato.
So I'm all nervous. We get up, and then he start. We get to the line, and yeah, fucking, we put in an order. And he's all like, "Yeah, dude, I listened to you guys on the train. I think he got introduced by El Compa Stowe."
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Sure. Because
he's all like, "Yeah, I know Stowe." I'm all like, "Oh, que toda madre."
I think.
No.
Ay, este wey.
Oh, my God. Okay.
I think. Ay, no. You know what? Now that I think about it, I think Stowe introduced him because he was like, "Hey, I know El Compa Stowe."
So, so he was telling me that
he put two and two together.
He listens to it on the train. Mm. Yeah, he takes the train and he's listening to it. Right now, he was on episode with Big Citric.
Oh, shit.
He was on that episode. Well, that was like a week ago. So I don't know.
I don't know his pace. I don't know his life.
But he's all like, "Yeah, man, you guys are funny. Que sabe que."
But I know his tía.
So yeah, no, it's too chingón. So yeah, ya comimos, and then we ended up going to a farmer's market, and then we went to a bookstore.
Oh yeah, you guys went to a bookstore?
Yeah, the what is it called? The
fake news. Esas no existen.
Is that where the
books have like they make the it into an aisle? Yeah. Yeah, that little arch.
No. This was on right there on 5th and Spring.
Mm. Yeah, no, the fucking one bookstore.
Yeah, the oldest bookstore.
Yeah, it has the arch.
You know what?
Everybody takes their picture right there.
Yeah, it's an Instagram.
Yeah, that's right.
Those Instagram spots.
No le puse tanta atención because fucking you gotta turn in your bag. Books. No, you gotta turn in your bag. Y casi te hacen el pinche search. Oh, whatever. Revisan. So I ended up.
What are you doing? I'm Ramon from Chicano Shuffle.
Ramon's like, "No, you guys don't have los novelas de Mexico, the little ones." The Cowboys.
El Vaquero.
My uncle used to be all into those speeches and novels.
Ando buscando la revista Alarma. Alarma. Dude, that was a rough
one. Oh, shit.
No tienen a Eres en la revista de los noventas.
I hear you guys do talks here. I'm here to do a talk.
¿Quién eres?
¿Tú quién eres, bro? Yeah.
Ay, güey. Eso estaba chingón, güey.
Estaba chingón esa revista, güey.
Yeah, fucking.
Salía la Sofía Vergara. She came out a few times on that. You know, back when the Kelly Kapowski, or ¿cómo se llama? The Kelly. No, not Kapowski. No, I get the wrong one. The one de pinche Married with Children.
Oh, Kelly Bundy.
Kelly Bundy. You remember the fucking 90s fucking bathing suits that were really high from the front?
Oh,
those were the ones que usaban en los 90s.
Ahí salía la Sofía Vergara. He has fun memories.
Yeah, she was pretty hot when she was. Well, todavía, güey. No, pero cuando estaba con.
La señora está guapa.
Sí, está guapa.
Está guapa.
Está guapona.
Ah, sí, 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 pues. Yeah. Oh, yeah, fucking the narcos. The
ya te salió lo narquillo.
No, pues sí, yo aguantó. Está sí, guapa. Aguanta. Sí, guapa. No. Esa plebe se aguanta.
Digo,
sí,
¿no?
It's
digo,
funny, ¿no? Los bitches. Like the one. Me aventé the regular one también, güey. I said, fuck, let me give it a shot. Mm-hmm. And it started slow, güey. I guess that's why I wasn't in it, but I fucking, it's a really good show también, güey.
¿Cuál, güey?
The old one, güey, that I didn't see it.
Which one? With the
Narcos.
That started with the Pablo Escobar.
Yeah, because it's the first season and second season is about Pablo Escobar. The third one is about los de Cali, los hermanos.
Los pinches, los caballeros de Cali, ¿no?
Yeah.
Some shit like that.
Con el.
Pero como hablan diferente, ¿no, güey?
Yeah.
Mal parido. Sentate. I told my girl, how come he doesn't say siéntate? Sentate. Yeah. Puta mal parido, dicen los cabrones. I was like, shit.
That sounds harsh.
Yeah.
It does.
Yeah.
And then they use the word because it's like there's certain words that I hear and I'm like, it kind of like cringe.
But
like,
you know what? Fucking my fucking little thing that I noticed is the subtitles, güey. Como la cagan, güey. Yeah. With the subtitles.
Yeah. It throws you off.
It's a different fucking show, güey, sometimes. I gotta tell my girl, no, that's not what he said, wait. Don't get fucking.
It was much better than that.
Don't take the story somewhere else. Y de tanto que le digo that I stop it, she's like, "Hey, why don't you do subtitles? You never thought about doing like fucking yeah, cállate, güey, pretty much. Why don't you fucking work, güey, if you complain so much, güey?
No, güey. For me, like when I'm watching the show. All right.
Mal parido. That's not bastard. That's fucking, you weren't raised properly. That's
no, you were birthed wrong.
Wrong. Like, wait, what? What's going on? Mal parido.
Doesn't mean he didn't have a dad.
I dissect mal parido. Okay, I guess bastard works. You know?
Oh my god.
Esa mierda.
No, and then the one they use a lot and it's like is marica.
Marica too, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like
yeah, that was a good old one from the
yeah, movie. But I'm like
se usaba un chingo.
I'm like, ooh. What? Like why I just do that like
se usaba un chingo, güey. Todavía se usa, yo digo, güey.
I don't know.
You're not in the fucking
yeah, I'm not in that
you're
scene.
You're in the Mexican scene, güey, no mames.
But even in the when I was young, yeah, decíamos ah, pinche maricón.
Puñal, güey.
Pinche
vato puñal.
Anywhere he's about marica.
I know, right?
Puñal.
Puñal.
Like, that one's like puñal.
But puñal is like a dagger or
yeah,
a blade.
A dagger. So whenever you don't want to say it and you just like you know, you look at your compa, you nod, and then you do the fist to your heart.
Puñal. Ay, güey.
Yeah, yeah, remember?
Yeah.
Te hacías los signs. And then the other one que te hacías es en el costado.
Yeah, remember?
En el costado. I never knew that one.
But it's como like puto, like the soccer one that we were talking about a few episodes back, or quite a few back. Okay, it doesn't really mean, it has nothing to do with like homosexuality.
No, it's just,
it's like if you fucking used an umbrella when it's raining. Ay, che puto. You know?
Está soleado. Está haciendo solecito. Ay, como chingada.
You know what I mean? Yeah. It doesn't mean anything about like sexuality, right?
It's no, just, it's just I guess different cultures. And
yeah, este güey wears sunblock, pinche puto.
Estás pateando ahí abajo, güey.
No, está cabrón.
Estás maltratando el pinche security, güey.
Speaking of animal, because este güey dando de patadas en la costilla.
Cállate,
en la costilla. Yo vi. Yo miré, güey, que le hiciste una patada en la costilla.
Quiere que la acaricie, güey. Quiere amor, nomás que estoy distraído acá con el show.
Con el show hablando de hijo de puta más parido.
Which is translated bad. Which apparently is not translated correctly.
No, it's not. Well, I mean, yeah, it gets bastard word, right? I mean,
bastard?
Mal parido?
I don't know.
Well, I think
at least I don't use that mal parido.
No,
that's because a lot of things tampoco don't translate well.
Yeah, don't translate properly.
Especially like when you're trying to do it in context, but you got to keep it like kind of in context.
Yeah.
Y por eso, como dices tú, the story has to change a little bit because
it changes.
Because
you
have to translate it and make it all kind of go together.
But you know, people that don't speak Spanish and they watch a show like Narcos, they don't get like most of the humor way.
No.
Because they change it in the subtitles.
Yeah, it doesn't translate right.
It doesn't.
So you're like listening, like, and then yeah, I'm
the only one laughing because my girls speak Spanish.
Oh no.
So me ando cagando yo la risa. Because to her it's bastard. To me it's mal parido. You know what I mean?
It's so much better.
Yeah, it's so much better, man.
Yeah, but you
might laugh at bastard, but parido.
I remember a while back when the first season came out.
Yeah.
Me tocó hacer un jale over here in Santa Monica, so I went to some little writing studios. And I end up finding out.
Patadas, man?
No, I don't know what she wants. ¿Quiere estar afuera? ¿Quiere estar
this adentro? Does sound like a relationship, but
you guys know. You guys know we're back at headquarters when security is crying over him, right?
I have no idea. Está afuera, está llorando. She's inside and she's crying.
¿Quiere la luz, güey?
Ah, she does.
She wants her name underlined.
I was I had to go do some fix some lines at a little it was like a writing studio.
Yeah.
And I'm talking to the guy and I end up finding out that they're responsible for the first season of Narcos.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I'm like, oh shit, you guys did Narcos. Man, love that show. Yeah, y estamos hablando. He's like, so what do you think? I'm like, you know what? I love how authentic it is.
So they were the writers for the first one?
Yeah. I'm like, I like how authentic it is, except for the fact that
what was their nationality?
Era güero. Era güero. You know, except for the actor. I know he's Brazilian and he
has
the
look.
The thing
Escobar
guy? Yeah, his accent.
Mm.
You could tell it wasn't authentic. Everybody else?
Mm.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, dude. Tienen el acento, son colombianos.
Yeah.
You know, this guy was Brazilian.
Yeah.
And the thing is that
makes sense, I guess. Yeah.
So, like, you could tell that he spoke slowly. just to get the right words, but it didn't change the dynamic of it. But I told him, like, that's the only niche. But then I'm like, pinche Ramon, pa que dices algo? Just stay quiet.
So it's your fault that they killed him on the roof?
I changed the story.
Chiculero. Because like, Yui died?
That's why they changed the subtitles, man.
No, wait.
They're like, hey, we got the reviews. The people have spoken. Let's kill them off in the second season.
Este gordito.
Yeah, we can't do a Brazilian.
Company, dude.
We can't
do it did when I first started watching it, it kind of threw me off that it, like, he didn't speak it naturally. Where, you could tell something was a little off. Something was a little off, Wes, but after you watched it,
you know, those are herbal cigarettes that they smoke. They're not real cigarettes. Mm-mm. They make them out of like herbs and shit.
Yeah. It's the same.
I think some of them, the ones that they use a lot, they're called ecstasy. That's the pack.
Oh, okay.
These ecstasy. But some of their herbs, like rose petals or some weird shit like that. Yeah.
I'm going to get some of those. I'm going to get some of those to hang out with you, Vatos. So I can be in the patio.
Get
también.
With the pipe, wait, what's up?
So, también they used to use those for the cigarette smoking man in X-Files.
Mm.
And X-Files, ese cabrón siempre fumaba.
The smoking man.
Mm-hmm. Fucking siempre fumaba. And yeah, they were always herbal cigarettes.
Yeah, I think that's the industry standard. Yeah.
Unless caen un cabrón que diga, no, a mí me dan mis pinches.
A mí me vale madre. What actor you would think?
A mí me traen mis pinches faros.
What actor you think would be a badass like that way?
Now or then?
Now.
Shit.
¿Se sabe que a mí no me vengan con esas mamadas? Give me your fucking Marlboro Reds.
You know who? Emiliano Rivera.
Yeah?
Yeah, el de Sons of Anarchy. Yeah, because I know that he smokes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you see pictures, like, you know, social media.
He smokes?
Media. Yeah, él fuma.
But even if you smoked, way.
Si la cagas
on the set, they're probably not going to let you smoke, way. Porque no, everybody va a chillar.
There's California law, way.
Yeah, then van a chillar.
Yeah, you can't smoke.
You can't smoke here, bro. But we're filming. Nope.
Yeah.
The character clearly says.
Here's your vegan cigarette.
¿Qué tal cuando se tiene que echar un perico, way? Is there real fucking. ¿Cómo le hacen, güey?
¿Cómo le hacen, ma, güey?
Yeah. Baby formula?
They
baby formula. Fucking sounds worse.
They crumble that little steak que viene con el fun dip, remember?
Oh, yeah.
the
fun dip, el que viene con el fun dip, that is the fun dip.
No, pero the fun dip is, you dip it, that's why they call it fun dip, but the little steak, way.
Fucking so simple.
Your subtitles are right?
So simple, fucking. Ese güey se hizo millonario with un pinche hard candy.
Yeah.
With fucking
powder
candy.
A sugar.
Oh, just sugar.
Yeah.
And lo lambes.
Flavored sugar.
And it sticks. Remember that technology when it came out?
Yeah.
So you mean I licked this and... Oh,
what?
Shit.
Boom. Mind blown. No,
and it comes in two separate pouches?
Yeah. No, mames. This is technology. Nah, we're doomed.
Pero si estuviera chingón que Fonseca, they're like, here are your vegan cigarettes, whatever. You're like, no way. I got these from the paletero. It's cool.
Yeah, right? The bubblegum ones.
I'm good.
That's the era we were in, huh? We could buy fucking bubblegum cigarettes.
And you're
from
like
the paletero.
Standing with your compas, este con la bici, fumando tu chicle, güey.
Yeah. No mames,
the times,
esos
man.
Tiempos.
Yeah.
And now they have to sell vegan food at the airport.
Yep.
I mean, everything that we had to go through, the simple things to the difficult things. I mean, the simple things were like, fucking, quería sacar dinero porque no te dan tu domingo, whatever, you recycled cans.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Simple. I mean, pero even from fucking hacer travesuras or like fucking to get your porn stash or your stash of porn, way.
Yeah.
Fucking you had to.
Yeah, right.
You had to fucking find a way.
You had to be a fucking.
Ahora, pinche. En el pinche teléfono, way.
Yeah.
Todo fácil.
Well, some of the shit I see on YouTube would be good material when I was a kid.
The Sears catalog estaba chingón back then.
Just go on YouTube, you get some good material. Like, fuck, where was this when I was fucking 14?
Estuvieras todavía encerrado, güey.
Ay, güey.
Yeah, no, güey. So,
ya hemos cambiado, güey.
Yeah, the times, everything changes, güey. Everything fucking changes. But yeah, fucking, La ciclavia was chingón, güey.
Oh, yeah.
Is that what we're talking about?
Ciclavia.
Is that how we got to fucking narco?
And the thing is, I got his name. I know it was either Alex or Angel, güey.
Mm. Pues.
Ya no me acuerdo cuál era.
Mm?
Alex. I want to go with Alex.
You
Alex.
Think so?
Yeah, it's Alex.
Ángel.
No. Alejandro.
Ángel is a kind of tough name to fucking. ¿Por qué no puedes ser desmadre? Your name's Ángel.
Oh, it's kind of a
el contradiction. Arcángel.
El ángel desmadroso, güey.
Yeah, güey. Yeah, you're right. Ángel del infierno, como el grupo. Los ángeles del infierno.
Fucking me. Yeah. But no, yeah, it was a good little ride. The Mija and I were thinking of every year. Well, do you remember when we used to do the bike rides on New Year's Day? On New Year's Day?
Yeah.
I remember bike rides, but yeah, was it New Year's Day?
Venice? Yeah, in Venice. We're thinking of bringing it back, way.
Yeah. I kind of like my New Year's to be chill.
I know.
I'm used to my years being chill, güey.
Yeah?
No, don't start making shit up, güey. Déjalo descansar, güey. No mames.
No, I'm not going to force
you. Luego te agüitas de uno show up, güey.
No. Si me dicen que sí van a ir y no vienen, entonces me agüito.
Yeah.
Pero si me dicen, nah, I can't make it. Nah, me voy a quedar. Ah, de pedo, güey.
Tienes un corazón muy grande en tu Ramón.
And you have a firme podcast.
¿Qué quieres para Navidad, güey? ¿Qué quieres que te regale?
Ya viene la Navidad.
¿Qué se te antoja para Navidad?
Oh. The way you say, güey. Nah, I can't trust
you. Because the Esteban Banco over there.
I know, right? Mm. Yeah. No, para empezar ya, güey. I mean, it's time, güey.
You know what? Me quieren dar un regalo, güey. Llévame a taquear, güey.
Yeah?
Yeah. Fucking, you know what? I want to go try el Día de los Puercos. Yeah, that's
that Momo, el compa de Momo.
Yeah,
¿no?
El compa de Momo, but there was an article on him.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were interviewing him, and it's like he went from, I think, what was it?
I didn't get to
Covina to
that's
Pomona.
That's the one that I'd seen, and then that's what I was asking. Remember, did he close? What happened to them?
He moved. Yeah, he moved to Pomona now. Mm. And it's, dude, I was looking at the pictures and the way they were describing it, or the reporter was, or the writer was describing it. Is that like it's very fucking nostalgic, dude. Like inside they have like telephone poles with the telephone wires, and they got the tennis shoes on top.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh,
fucking ordenas tu tall boy in a paper bag.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Oh shit, please.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
They got fucking murals. That you know from the hood, like and one of them is like the 6th Street Bridge. Like if you were like getting into it, you know, ya no está.
Que en paz descanse.
Yeah. I mean, the fucking bridge had concrete cancer, or had cancer or something on the concrete.
Yeah, concrete cancer. Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, yeah, no, it wasn't gonna be safe. I mean, you could still leave it for nostalgic reasons, but al rato fucking.
Wow. Sale la demanda.
Yeah, no, pinche.
La demanda.
Moridera. Oh, moridera. It's not even a word.
Your subtitles are awful.
I know.
Moridera.
Moridera. What the fuck?
Like, you meant to say like a massacre? Like
yeah,
a mass kind of.
Masacre, güey.
Se mueren more than one person?
Es como, fuck, moridera.
Moridera. Es que el puente estaba mal parido.
Madre, güey. Pinche cerebro. Took two words and.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Sometimes some words, como, ¿es liqueando a word?
Well, no, it's derived from leaking.
Yeah, no, but it's not a word. Yeah,
it's not a word.
Sometimes
but
I catch myself in the hallway. Oh, it's just leakando. I'm like, wait, leakando is not a fucking
no.
word.
No,
cuando dices, vete a parquear allí, güey. Ahí hay parking.
Ahí hay parking. Yeah.
I'm like, what the fuck?
Está leakando.
Está leakando.
There's a lot of them, dude.
Yeah.
And the thing is, because maybe. We
it's
do.
A pocho thing.
Yeah, it's
or Chicano.
Yeah, it's a Chicano pocho thing. Dude.
Yeah, taliquiano.
Taliquiano.
Yeah, it could come about another way, but yeah.
But there's more, and I can't think of them right now. But one of them is.
You said one on the pod on a few episodes back that I was gonna bring it up. It sounded pretty funny.
You're gonna clown me?
Yeah, because you said it. You literally translated the way it is in English to Spanish, but I was like, nah, that doesn't sound right.
I used to do a lot of those. Yeah. En el Pináculos con este güey. And I remember when I first conocí, me miraba así como dices tú.
What the fuck are you doing, güey?
Yeah.
Dude. Yeah. I used to ponchar. Like
ponchar to clock in?
Yeah.
Vamos a ponchar.
Let's punch in.
It's not a word?
I don't think ponchar. I mean, ponchar is like flat. So, Se ponchó. Yeah, deflate.
También ponchar is, people used to use it to punch, no?
No, ponchar no. Eso es pegar, güey. Eso es golpear o.
Yeah. Ponchar is it literally someone took punch and made it.
No, tampoco esa, güey. No, ponchar is.
I heard ponchar as like a punch, like they fucking straight from punch to ponchar.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think ponchado is like deflator, because está ponchado, you know?
No, well, it's that too.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
They took in
punch.
English
yeah,
and kind of like made their own translation. Como like we were saying the other words, like parquear.
Or ponche.
Parquear doesn't
exist. También el ponche, no, punch.
Vienen tus primos de México. Yeah. Le dices, hey, parqueate allí, güey. And they're, yeah. What the fuck?
What is that?
Me estaciono allí.
Yeah.
Shit. Well, fuck, there's plenty of them, and I'm sure, like, if you guys know fans out there, fucking mándanos el pinche.
Send us your list.
Yeah, send us your list, dude. We want to see if we could get a couple.
There must be some regional shit, too, way.
Yeah, I'm brain farting right now.
There is regional, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. There must be some regional ones we never heard, way.
Yeah. Pero también el este, fucking, I was talking to el pinche Chapo, el amor de Chicano.
My dearest Chapo.
Ya, se comenzar. Can't say anything, dude. Right away. But again, I was just, because it's been a while since I heard from him. So I'm like, hey.
You're checking in? Hey, Chapo, be careful, bro. Because that's how he does the people in our circle. Hey, so what's up?
Watch out, because if no le contestas, he's going to show up at your door.
Yeah, bro. Good thing you don't live close to him, because he'll go knocking unannounced.
If you find some cheap flights, I was with.
Ramon llega como el DEA looking around like, all right, cool.
Él le abre la puerta and he's looking, yeah, like,
he's looking around like, what's going on here? Okay, they still have electricity, so they can charge their phone still. They should still text me. All right.
I see an open laptop. He can do some damage there with emails.
Jesus, man. You know, I care for people.
Oh, is that the phone in your pocket?
I care for people.
Oh, so you still have Instagram, right?
I just, you know, sometimes seeing them in person is better than, you know, a text or a call.
Most of the time, I think, you know?
I've seen on Instagram the little green light is on.
I don't know what you guys heard. I don't know what you guys been told, but I, you know.
Yeah, son rumores. Son rumores.
No, it happened. I show up to people's
houses. Yes, I would though. Let's just.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not story with them.
Let's talk about George W.
No,
Bush.
I'm still trying
let's
to
go back
this
to talking about el Chapo.
The puerco. I'm still talking. So I was hitting him up a ver cómo estaba. So he was saying that he was getting over a flu, no, and that sure. It was like 21 degrees
estaba
over
malón.
There. Yeah.
Estaba malón.
Estaba malón.
Estaba Carl Malone.
Estaba bien Carl Malone.
No, pues malón. So that shit still fucking crazy. Me up. Okay, it was 21 degrees. I'm like, no mames. Or 24, but still, I'm like, dude, acá estaba 61 el otro día. Yo sentí que me iba, yo creí que me iba a dar una pulmonía, güey. 61 degrees. I'm like, holy shit, dude. He's like, yeah, dude, over here, like, it's either snowing, raining, or hailing.
We're so spoiled out here, man.
Dude, we are.
Tuvimos lluvias esta week, no? They built a brand new Walmart by my house, like, not even a year ago. No mames, güey. I walked in there the day it was raining. Un chingo de pinches, those fucking, like, bins. Uh-huh. Cause that shit was leaking, güey. I think you just built it not even a year ago, and it's already leaking, güey?
No. Even the Walmart is built cheaply,
no mames, güey.
Oh, shit.
We're so vulnerable with our infrastructure sometimes. Y las luces también, güey. The lights.
Well, if it feels leaking, yeah. Ya vale madre.
Man. It's we're spoiling, California. Yeah, it's not even a year that they built it, way. It's still todo chingón, way. And it was fucking leaking in a few aisles.
That's a bad fucking build, way.
Yeah, no mames.
Didn't you Walmart even cheaped out on the build, way?
They did, way. They hired non-union workers.
No, they were trying to use that, what is it? That infomercial sure spray paint on the fucking stops leaks.
Yeah. Oh, my God, wey, that's such a joke, wey. I know which one you're talking about. Que un barco también,
yeah, no, agarra, le hacen un hoyo una pinche lancha, and then they put one of those doors over it, and lo sellan, wey.
Te fíjate, wey.
Watcha.
Chécale.
Nothing comes through.
That's not what Amazon says. You look at the reviews on Amazon. Everybody's complaining, wey.
My boat sucked.
Quedé náufrago.
Yeah, right.
No chingas, güey.
Ay, güey.
No, shit. But fucking lo bueno, at least what I like about this time of year, hay muchas cosas, güey. I don't care for the rain, but you're inside, tapadito, fucking catching up on shows or movies or lo que sea.
Yeah.
Fucking ahí, you know. So, you know, loved ones or lo que sea. Fucking right now, fucking The Last Dragon is on Netflix. Pinche 80s classic, dude.
The Last Dragon?
Yeah. Like, show enough. kiss my converse. You know, who's the meanest? Sure enough, who's the baddest? Sure enough.
I gotta watch it now.
Who's the meanest mofo around? Sure enough.
I gotta watch it while listening to this so I can laugh at what he's saying.
And reading the subtitles.
I wonder. You should do it in Spanish subtitles, that one. A ver cómo sale.
A ver cómo sale chingón.
Sure enough, in Spanish, how would that be?
The Spanish subtitles están chidos, güey. Yeah, like I've seen The Simpsons in Spanish and
well, then so the
Shrek in Spanish is una chingonería.
Mejor,
yeah, it's una chingonería.
The dubbed, right?
Yeah,
no, no mames, Shrek.
Shrek in Spanish está chingona, güey.
They get away with some shit,
es
too.
Eugenio Derbez is a donkey.
Yeah.
There's a few in Spanish que están mejor que in English, güey.
Sí, se la mamaron.
They get away with some fucking shit, too, for a kid's movie or whatever. No way. You gotta start watching some movies in Spanish, the cartoons, animated. The Shrek, fucking funny, man.
Trek's that chingona, man.
No mames, Trek. Me la comí toda. And he farts or whatever. Yeah.
Me la comí toda. Ay, güey.
No, right. And then we had a couple of we were getting a lot of fan interaction. Nos están mandando mensajes and they're like sending us posts.
Yeah, you're blowing up.
Well,
you're blowing up.
una que nos mandaron es Munch 71.
Uh-huh.
He's all like, hey, what do you guys think about fucking el ex manager de este Juan Gabriel saying that he's not dead, that he's gonna come back?
Cabrón. Cabrón, really? Oh shit, he's getting the stories from Don Chano and my mom. That's the source, right?
My Don Chano blog?
My dad told me that one too, man. When he was telling me lo de la esta
Donchano.com,
the caravan and all that. Okay, so he was telling me that que no, y que es que Juan Gabriel no está muerto, man. Like, te cree que bueno,
el Juanga's coming back.
I know. I'm like his back to life tour.
El que hizo el Tupac a few years back.
Psych.
The hologram.
I needed some time off.
But I'm like, who's gonna be stupid enough
to believe that?
to die or to fake their own death?
Yeah, marketing way, PR.
No, you, dude. Although it's not illegal to fake your own death just to change your life or lo que sea, you can't do it. You can't do it without breaking laws.
Yeah.
So it is illegal.
Yeah. It's not illegal to.
To disappear?
To disappear. But in the process of doing it, you're going to break laws.
So it's illegal.
Yeah. No es como que digan, dude, you can't fake your own death. You know, but you can fake your own death, but just know that.
But don't put laws. It on paper. Yeah. No, you can't put it on paper, way.
And then not only that, but there's going to be like anybody that helps you out, they're going to fall into the conspiracy.
That's called fraude.
Yeah, it's fraud. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So it's illegal.
Yeah. So I don't think Juan Gabriel, si ya dicen que se murió, because here's the weird thing.
Mm-hmm.
A lo que dicen, as soon as he passed away, a los que 2 días lo enterraron.
Like everything was quick.
Yeah, everything was so quick. Mm-hmm. And like, you know.
Tiene feria, güey.
I'm sure.
They didn't have to fucking do a car wash for him, güey. Para ver que le saquen, güey. He has money, güey.
I'm a nice dude, he says.
Yeah, fuck it, lo que sea, güey.
People think I'm an asshole.
Yeah. That's not being an asshole, way. I'm just pointing to facts.
Yeah, he's real.
Hey, facts don't pay. Don't care about feelings, man.
Yeah, no, tampoco. It was nothing like shady, way. He just he died, no?
Yeah, heart attack.
That's what I'm saying. So there was no.
It's not like he was like.
You don't have to wait back for the report.
They were extraditing him to the state.
You know where he died at? In Santa Monica, but right there by hot dog on the stick.
Ah, cabrón.
Oh, he died in Santa Monica? I didn't know he died in Santa Monica.
He died in Santa Monica.
So he was eating hot dog
in la calle o qué pedo?
No. He had
that makes sense.
Yeah.
It was like, I guess, I don't know if it was his property or Airbnb or he rented it or
lo que sea.
Shit. But it's right there, right on the fucking,
CS Airbnb, let's fucking book it for a night and we'll do the podcast right there. Se nos aparece Juan Gabriel. We'll ask him.
Are you coming back?
We'll ask him. Hey, qué pedo?
Straight out. You coming back? Donchano.com says you're coming back.
Las pendejadas, wey. ¿Vas
yo
a venir?
No, oh, no nací para amar.
Imagine. And we start hearing that.
No, Juanga.
Se te pareció el Juanga, Ramón. Se te pareció. Ah, no, es Liberace, güey. Wrong Airbnb, güey. Ay, güey.
Oh shit, man.
Man, think it's a taparesca, Juanga?
I'm not saying, man. I mean,
kind of crazy.
I mean,
would it be the young Juanga or the old Juanga?
I don't know, but
which one would you prefer?
¿Va a ser el mañoso Juanga o el respetuoso Juanga? I don't know. See, the thing is that a lot of people say he was gay. A lot of people say he wasn't gay. A lot of people say, like, well, I don't know. Uh-huh. You know, some people say that he played the role. Oh, that's another Don Chano conspiracy.
Uh-huh. Donchano.com?
Yeah, Donchano.com. So it's like, que Juanga no era gay.
Oh, your dad says
that? Yeah, que no era gay. Okay. Que él le daba al público lo que el público quería.
Oh, shit.
Right?
So pero el público quería que sea gay?
Because they really fell in love with it, you know? It's like beautiful music.
I feel like that's how our parents coming up with the reason for him not to be gay.
Exactly.
Yeah, I know, right? You know, it's not a Catholic. It's not very Catholic of him.
It's not, yeah.
Es católico, no.
Luego que, pues, ¿cómo puede ser gay si tenía tantos hijos? I'm like, oh, come on.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on, dad. Yeah. No, que era bien mujeriego. Siempre tenía mujeres like,
Yeah.
Like, all right.
Maybe we went both ways.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe that's why everybody's confused.
Era moderno en los ochentas.
Yeah. Probably when was he probably just liked the potty, Wayne.
Ay, those are funny. Ways. Dude, your dad should have a podcast, Wayne. We should put it on Patreon también, Wayne.
We should bring him in.
Bring him in, Wayne. Record him. What kind of wisdom he has,
Wayne. No, the thing is that
because the source is pretty funny.
I think he gets camera shy, or like, you know, he'll get shy.
No,
like,
well, it's not. I know it's not like sometimes you read stuff, the fans are like, hey, wait, this said this así, mm-hmm. or this was that. Mm-hmm. Like, pretty much, why didn't you guys get it? Because we're in it, right?
Yeah.
But when you have the mics in front of you and you're recording, it's a different dynamic, no?
Mm-hmm.
It's not as easy as fucking whatever you guys are doing out there. I don't know. But it's like when the pelean the UFC. Hey, what the fuck? You should have fucking done this. You should have done that.
Yeah.
And you're like, wait, no mames. Put yourself in that fucking cage in the pay-per-view.
La llave, güey.
I know, güey.
La llave. Este güey. Llave.
No mames. Yeah, it's Ramón with the triple A over here.
I know.
El rudo.
No, but yeah, it was so we had a lot of interaction with the fans. Like one of them was a brown Jedi master. He was throwing props on the Spotify list.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Nice, bro. You getting some traction?
Yeah. I think the next one I'm working on is the fucking freestyle high energy.
Oh shit.
Workout mix.
I know, it's just, you know, like, you know, the it's
for the graffiti artists out there, I like to keep it old school.
Oh yeah, or like, you know, what you gonna do when you get out of jail?
The Tom Tom Club?
Yeah. You know, or Sinola de, what is it, Atomic Dog?
Mm.
Bow, wow, wow, yippee, oh, yippee.
Oh, sure.
He look a week ago.
No, sure.
Yeah, so it's got a lot of those. I'm working on them. The only one I can't find on Spotify is Number One Lover.
No está ahí?
No está, güey.
Oh, shit.
They probably don't want
the licensing.
Yeah, they don't have the derecho.
Number one. Mm. Number one.
Pues fuck it, we'll do that next. Si la pones ahí, güey.
Mix it in.
No, I'm working for the next ones. I'm working on the Christmas.
Oh, we're doing Christmas songs?
Yeah.
No, shit. You're going to wear your little Santa hat, okay?
You know what? I didn't think about it. Maybe I should.
Yeah.
I'll do the pinche, where the Sancho Claus
fucking hat. Sancho Claus.
No mames. Ay, güey. So Juan Gabriel's coming back, huh?
Apparently.
Fucking the people have spoken.
You know, but
is he going
like,
to Coachella next year or qué?
He's gonna start on Los Palenques, güey. You know, you gotta start off small, you know?
Los Palenques.
En las ferias de pinche.
De Pico Rivera.
De Pico Rivera, Sports Arena.
Ahí en Sports Arena. Arena,
man. Con los caballos, los caballos quedan de pinche John Sebastian, güey.
Well, nowadays, güey, you gotta fucking make it to the casino, güey.
The casino, oh, yeah. Estar ahí en el morongo.
El Fantasy Springs.
Ah, no mames, güey.
You gotta do the
casino circuit.
You gotta start it off right there. You pick up momentum, and next thing you know, hey, fucking luego vienen los sports arenas.
That sucks, huh? La trayectoria de los músicos.
Wow, yeah. Está cabrona, güey. Yeah. You gotta put in your time, güey.
Some of those, like...
casinos are big now, the way they... All the concert things that I see, all the advertisements are for fucking
casinos. They're dropping money onto it. But, like, como sometimes, like... I mean, I know it's not the same industry, but some of those, like, old WWF wrestlers... standing like little fucking comic book stores like in Culver City. Like, you know what? Check this thing's gonna be here.
Like, I respect that though, because a lo que sea, they're like, you know what, it's for the
fans. That's a tough gig where you're the wrestler.
It's for the fans, but not only that, but it shows the caliber of the person and the sentido, like, you know what, I'm above this.
You think that's what it is, or they're trying to pay their bills way and they're
they're trying to pay their bills way.
The caliber at the moment.
I don't know. I mean, some of them I'm sure.
Porque también es the attention way, because I mean they're used to attention, and when they go to these places, like como dice este way,
those kids get out, or not even kids now, because they're probably guys
our age. They do. They'll make a little line and all the way, so they get their attention. To us, it doesn't sound as big. You know, it's not as big.
But como the hustles, the Comic Cons way, because they the headshots, autograph, like the guys that go into Comic Cons,
$25, $30 bucks. Y unos güeyes
tienen pinche línea bien grande, güey.
Yeah,
all that's
what I'm saying. So it's the attention. They still get the attention. I don't think it's just for the fans, way.
No.
I'm sure there's probably a bunch of them that do it again for the fans, but I mean, como es este way to make.
There's still a niche for them out there. There's still a little niche.
Yeah.
There's people that still admire their work from 20 years ago or 10 years ago.
Yeah.
30 years ago. There's some old dudes.
I know that there's a lot of actors or musicians that I would still look up to.
Mm-hmm.
And even though they were big 20 years ago, I'm like, for me, they're still like, you know what? Fuck, dude.
Like who? What's an example?
Who would it be? Ahorita. Que si el pinche el piporro estuviera vivo, güey.
Yeah.
Fuck it, I'll go look for el piporro. Like, hey, ¿qué onda, compa?
You know? Ahí va a estar en el Trato Los Pinos en Safi. Ahí en la Twitter.
El show de Francis.
That spot, el Trato Los Pinos, was one of those, like, when the guys are already kind of like their careers, they peaked, they would go there y se presentaban en Los Pinos, güey.
Yeah.
Those little fucking. ¿Te acuerdas el Allen Theater también, güey? That would have been a cool spot to fucking
the one on
turn into something, right?
I've always... So I think I've talked about
it's
this.
It's like an abandoned theater. That was pretty
one
cool.
One of my things was I always want to... If I ever came to money, or like, donde digo, ¿sabes qué? Fuck, ya pagué la casa, ya pagué esto. I don't have to work. I got some walking around money. I would like to open up a movie theater. And just play old movies.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
Yeah, they tried that way.
No, he says he would do it.
I would do it.
That would be his hustle.
Like, for example, one weekend will be fucking Cheech and Chong weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And
so can you smoke weed in there or no? How do you feel about that?
Oh, shit. I'm just using an example.
I don't know. These are details that matter. Where
I know. Oh, well, I would have to get security and make sure that.
But you would be cool if they smoked in there.
No, well, because I could get in trouble.
I don't know if you need security as much as you need futons.
I know. Right away, they're gonna get crazy.
Well, fuck it. Maybe I won't. I could do a killing on Hot Pockets and fucking
you
Cheetos,
what I
mean, and Hot Cheetos.
You'll never make so much money in the conventions.
Hello, you play Scarface and everybody wants to do coke.
I know.
You can hand out the fun dip.
Oh, this coke is blue.
Shit. Fucking. And then
it burns my nose.
Like, have like a Bruce Lee weekend.
I know. Right? You know, it like burns my nose.
Like Kung Fu Theater. You know?
Yeah.
And just have it like that. Like, you know, just reminiscing to old people, like to the back in the days.
That's super niche, way. I don't know. You have to have a shit ton of money because the fuck is possible.
It's like the one that the Tarantino bought, the one where they try, where they play all the old movies.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, he bought it because they were
going to knock it down, right?
No, they're going to close it because they weren't making money, güey. Tarantino bought it.
Estaría chingón to have shows there también, though, güey. Se presta to have shows también, güey.
I've always liked the one that you used to tell me, the one you told me that you like, if you could, you would call you'll get a bar or like a little, you would call it the rooftop.
Mm-hmm.
Remember?
I remember that, yeah.
And I'm like, holy shit.
That was a long time ago.
Dude,
bro.
Yo me acuerdo, güey.
Yeah.
And you're
como
like,
estás hablando de carnitas, que he has like.
Yeah, the phone line.
So this will be like if you're playing out in the roof.
Yeah, the rooftop. Yeah, like it looked like it was in the roof.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I forgot about that one.
Because we can afford the actual roof.
Yeah.
Patent pending.
I know, right? Nah, the roof's a liability, way. Like where we rehearse at the studio in LA, it's literally a parking structure, way. Four floors, and on top's that studio, and they're always talking about throwing events up there, pero the liability, way. There's no net, there's nothing, way. You're on like the fifth floor. Yeah. You do some damage right there, man.
Ramon! Yeah, so that's always been like one of those things that I've always wanted to have, like a little movie theater, you know?
Like a movie theater?
Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I could fucking hang out there. Like, I could work it. I could just fucking watch movies.
Yeah.
But you can't smoke porque he needs security.
Yeah, you can't smoke.
It's like, you know, I mean, unless I had like a smoking license.
Mm-hmm.
then yeah, I don't know. I think that's next, don't you think?
For the cannabis?
Yeah, like in businesses or areas, like you have to have a certain license for drinking. Mm.
They have that. I mean, I think they're already doing something like that.
But I get what you're saying. Yeah, that's the next. Yeah. That's the next kind of move. But everybody, you know, like the narcos and all these movies that sometimes we watch that they smoke everywhere. The old ones, they smoke in a plane. Like, that's not the culture that we're in anymore.
No.
Like, no, I mean, I like to smoke pipe tobacco, and I feel sometimes I have to, like, and pour me, right? But sometimes you, out of respect, te llevan hasta la pinche esquina. No, it's
the next block.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like, you know, why?
I don't want people smelling my shit.
If not only that, it's just annoying them.
You have to be respectful.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's why sometimes certain people that when they, I don't have a problem with weed, but when they smoke it and there's kids around, wait, eat a fucking edible way.
Yeah.
Like, don't fucking... The smoke aquí, like, nobody wants to smell that shit, right?
Not only that, but, like, let's just say, you know, you're at a gathering.
Yeah.
There's just some people that might smoke it, but not everybody smokes.
Yeah.
You know, like, well, fuck, you know, step away.
Yeah.
Unless you're with the compas y todos están fumando, tomando, lo que sea. Es otro pedo.
Yeah.
You know, but there's, like, you know, don't expose people to your fucking vices, you know?
But sometimes I feel some guys do it para chingón, way. I want to be the cool one smoking a blunt right now.
Yeah.
Like, wait, come on. You're fucking 42, wait, no mames.
Eso es like the dudes that put over here in their pocket, wait, para que lo vean todos.
Yeah. That's just like, wait, gets a tattoo on his arm and just one sleeve is up. Y si apenas se ve that little fucking tattoo, oh, yeah, para que le pregunten, hey, wey.
¿Qué tienes?
Oh, they get a new watch, wey. Están así.
¿Cómo están? Oh, ¿qué horas?
Oh, yeah. Shit, wey. Ya son las pinches tres. Yeah, so nomás, I feel sometimes it's para pantallar, wey. Like, I'm the cool guy smoking a fucking blunt right here.
There's a lot of that, way.
But that way?
Yeah. There's a chingo that way.
Pero pues está cabrón, está café el virote. Como decía el tío de Tijuana.
Y luego, whatchamacallit, pinche, well, sí, estamos hablando de donchano.com conspiracies, right?
Yeah. He's got another one?
No, you know how he was
plenty,
saying,
man.
Yeah.
That's a funny.
You know how we were talking about that he thought that la que no come frijoles was going to get asylum? Que había agarrado.
Oh, yeah.
She got it.
Oh, she did?
Yeah, she's in Texas.
I told you, way.
She's in Texas.
I told you que la están armando, but it fucking...
Yeah, she's in Texas. I was looking.
She probably got away.
Dude, like pinche social media, you know, at least a lot of the raza, they're like, they're pissed.
Are you serious, man?
Yeah, they're pissed. I'm all like, yeah, you know what? Part of it is la gente que they made that happen for her. You know, para que se van a encabronar? It was, you know, she got what she wanted. She got
Ramon
smart.
Se la comió toda. I remember we're arguing with him. He's like, no, but it's her sister said.
Yeah.
This is her sister was saying.
Yeah. Que no la encuentran en el face.
Pinche Don Chano.
No la encuentran en el face.
Pinche Don Chano called it.
Yeah, Don Chano's on it, I like his source, man.
Yeah, anyway.
Yeah.
Muerta,
that's her funny way. Like my dad, he went to he crossed over from Tijuana to San Diego para el casino con mi uncle ayer. Y hablé con él. Le dije, you know, they become our kids. Way you have to make sure they take their pills and make
check
sure
in.
They eat. So it was around 6. So I go, hey, ¿apá comió qué? He's like, yeah, comí comida coreana en el pinche en el casino. Le digo, ah, cabrón, coreana como la barbecue, como la carne. Y me dice. No, estaba medio raro. Era arroz con spaghetti, me dice.
Arroz con spaghetti.
El ramen, güey. He called the ramen spaghetti, güey.
Arroz con spaghetti.
Y le digo, ay, jefito, un día me va a tocar estar de su edad y así también me va a pasar a mí.
Imagínate.
Que arroz con spaghetti, dice, güey.
Arroz con spaghetti. Y mucho caldo.
Demasiado caldo.
Y con un huevo. No sé, ni con tortilla me dieron, que si él quiere tortilla para todo, güey.
Yeah, güey, porque...
Dads are funny, güey.
At least he doesn't walk around con un chingo de chiles en su bolsita, güey.
No.
Como Don Chano. Yeah. I don't know now. I gotta ask him.
No, es contrabando.
No, pues ya
es contrabando.
Desde su operación, güey.
Oh, pues ya, it's a different person now.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. He is, but fuck it.
That's pretty cool, güey.
So I just figured out fucking... Something, way I just remember, way put it, so I'm gonna bring it up. El pinche, el Michael Miguelito Jackson, on the kind on the fence, the you know, fucking, apparently this is a very divisive fucking question, way. On the kind on the fence on his pedophileness, way.
Look, I've heard, so there was this story about how him and Freddie Mercury were like fucking great friends. mm-hmm. right? Eran pinches amigos chingones. They had a fallout. Nobody knew what it was. Later on down the years, they found out that Michael Jackson caught Freddie Mercury fucking Betty Candle or shooting up.
But he must have been young when they were friends, no?
Yeah. He was young. Todavía tenía el pinche chango. Y todavía no se hacía...
Yeah.
So a lot of... there was a lot of rumors that okay, Michael Jackson was disappointed because he saw Freddie Mercury as his friend and then for his friend been doing this. Somehow they broke it down where like Michael Jackson was very childlike. He never grew out of that stage.
That's always been my fucking thing. That he mentally, pues, he never developed past like.
Well, they say sometimes when you have like his dad was a abusive piece of work, man. Yeah. So they say sometimes when you have an incident as a kid when it's like really like traumatic, you kind of stump like te quedas ahí esa la way. So that might have happened to him. Where,
I'm sure that's what happened to him.
Yeah, because like all like as a kid. Because yeah, so, I mean all that Disneyland shit, all that.
Yeah, the what was it? The pinchy the rides and the merry-go-round and the Ferris wheel.
But everything went.
Yeah, and you know, so a lot of people.
They say que según con Macaulay Culkin también, no.
These
no,
kids.
But Macaulay Culkin is like was like one of his biggest supporters.
No,
But they kept
trying to put it on him. And
yeah, Macaulay Culkin is fucking. He went through some shit too, though.
He went through some shit, yeah.
You know, but
I was because I figured out way. The conversation came up, Wayne. I seen the fucking in fucking El Grupito, and there was a heated argument way about there. Like, there's people that are like hardline. Yeah, pinche música está chingón, but this vato's a fucking pedophile. Fuck that dude. Mm. And the other one's like, no way, fucking take es puro pedo. Mm. And I was like, dick, I didn't know this shit was like so divisive. It's like when it was like a Trump thing. Like it was like that fucking divisive where people were arguing when you're like, wait, serio? Like, I didn't know it was this hardcore that people were like so set on their mindset that he was pedophile or he wasn't. Like, it's a hard line.
Oh, so they don't listen to the music and they don't care for the music because they're like, no, me vale madre. This guy was a pedophile.
But what I'm saying is the line is hard, way. Like, you're not going to convince this dude and you're not going to convince this dude otherwise. There's no middle ground. He was or he wasn't. And I was like, what the fuck?
The thing is here is that it's all hearsay. Nothing's been fucking proven. Maybe because a lot of people would say that he paid him off, you know?
But I mean, that my argument with that when that came up was they paid him off. And then when these kids grew up, a lot of them have said, my parents fucking
took advantage.
They kept telling me, hey, did this happen? Did this happen? And eventually, I was like, well, maybe. And then pinche demanda, right? Mm. And then it was the fucking parents out for the money, way. And, you know, once people grow up, they ask, todo, everything comes out now, way. Mm-hmm. Everything comes out now, and still no salido nada fucking nada. Positive, way.
Yeah.
So how do you justify saying, hey, este way was a fucking pedophile?
No, I don't think, well, I can't say anything because I never knew the man or anything, but a lo que se ve, he was spoiled in el sentido de que todo lo que él quería, like a kid.
He always had
it. He had people following him. You know, he had his staff. He acted like a child. I mean, he was a genius. He knew his music. He knew, you know, tenía todo. But as an adult, still a little part of him.
He was a little adult,
He was still childlike. And I don't think... you know what?
I don't think he was porque como te digo, ahorita ya sale todo, güey.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Everything comes out now. People grow up and they just fucking... I'm not going to say they just easily go out and tell their story.
Yeah.
Pero ya sale todo. Someone fucking tells this person, your fucking friend tells the world, you know? Mm-hmm. Type of deal. Now you have to tell your story because your friend told your story for you.
And especially now that he's passed away, like he can't disprove it.
That's what I'm saying.
And it would be easier for people to come out and say, well, yeah, I'm fucking, you know?
Yeah.
But I was just really surprised that line is fucking hard. Like people believe one thing. And the other people believe the other, and you convince no one in between.
Yeah, there's no evidence, but I mean, it doesn't mean that they paid them off. But I mean, it doesn't mean that like they're under a contract or lo que sea.
Yeah,
and that right there, está cabrón, pero hasta como dicen, hasta no ver no creer, or fucking until there's no proof. I'm like, you know what? The guy was just very spoiled. He was a child, you know, childlike, talented man. Fucking
I wouldn't
music.
Call him a man either, but we'll see. But he was
a talented individual.
He was a very talented.
But that's probably not by choice, because he's according to some people, he's supposed to be a castrato, where they take your balls out. They used to do that to opera singers. So he's, But they call that castrato because that's what they did to opera singers. Yeah. It's like so you don't pass puberty, so your voice is like really high.
Shit.
So him not being a man, it's maybe not even his choice way. I mean, he didn't have a
and
choice.
And if that's the case, then how about, doesn't mean just because you're castrated, doesn't mean you can't fucking abuse children or anything. But
yeah. Well, you don't produce testosterone. I mean, the drive is not there.
Well, that's true. I don't know.
So I don't have enough. I didn't really believe it. Way. I mean, I don't know. I don't think he did all that way. I just think he was like a confused. Yeah, he was just a eccentric person.
It's like the way I explained it too is like I can't remember the dude's name. I've been trying to remember right now. The dude that wrote it, was it Peter Pan? The one where fucking they even made a movie. That dude always is the one in sus tiempos. People said he was a fucking pedophile también, que porque he liked talking to kids and hanging out with kids, whatever. Mm-hmm. And he wrote a whole fucking book about staying childlike, you know? And you go, Dick, es que en esos tiempos, and even fucking, I guess, up into the 80s, if you liked hanging out with kids, and hey, what the fuck's wrong with this dude, güey?
Yeah.
Porque no quiere chelear con los otros, güey.
Yeah.
¿Qué pinche este güey que tiene? ¿Que le gustan los niños? Mm. All of a sudden, it morphs fucking... Like, I think the parents and us adults morph it into something more than it is, you know?
Yeah.
Although, I mean, they could be right. Who knows?
But, yeah. Well, yeah, it's definitely the parents' reaction, like you said, Wayne. Because I heard a psychologist talk about... I mean, as traumatic as it is to have a kid be molested, and a lot of the trauma is their parents' reaction. Oh fuck, what the fuck, he did what? And it's a natural instinct to react like that, but that also causes part of the trauma, right? Mm-hmm. Because you know it's not right, but the parents' reaction kind of make it, they kind of validate it, and they kind of validate the act, and sometimes that's a little bit,
that makes sense.
He's, and it's crazy to think
that, that would definitely add to it, Wayne. Yeah, that is crazy. That's what. That's pretty cabrón, güey.
Pero eso Michael Jackson, como dice Ramón, déjenlo descansar en paz, güey. Like, he's not here to defend himself, güey.
Yeah, you know what? He gave us music.
But that's a crazy society we're in, güey. I mean, we're not famous, güey. Nah. If we say...
Ramón, maybe.
But either way, if we think about it, güey, if we say something
that... They recognize Ramón in the streets, güey.
I know, right? If we say something that's like offensive to some people, and they fucking already put out a headline, if we're that known... Where somebody can put out a headline that says that you're a fucking child molester, even if they retract that and sale the same paper that says, oh no, that person's cool, the people are still gonna remember that first one. Mm-hmm. To them, you're always gonna be like, I don't know about this guy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Sí, pero porque también es tamañoso, güey, because like you're saying, they'll put the headline, front page it, on Machine, and then the retractions, like in the fucking middle, and like a little box.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you're like, that's not a retraction, güey.
Yeah.
Pero that's your life right there, güey. I'm not saying que no hay güeyes culeros, güey, que sí hay hijos de su puta madre, güey.
Oh, no.
There was a guy that my girl was telling me about that fucking molested a 14-month-old or some shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh, right here in South End? No.
I don't know where he was at, but they were looking for him.
Fuck, eso está cabrón, güey.
Está descarado, güey.
Dude, there was what was it? Otra cosa. There was a couple of stories that I stopped fucking reading them because there was...
Some of that shit agüita, güey.
Yeah, not too long ago, right here on Western and Vernon.
Yeah.
It was all shut down, dude. Salí de la chamba. Normally, it's a 23-minute ride on the train.
Yeah.
Esta vez duró como 45 minutos, güey. And the thing is, the train stop and go. Like, it would stop at the stations and like, oh, there's police activity ahead, so we're just waiting for this to come down. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Finally, ya cuando me salgo, vengo en el pinche Irby. And it's like, fuck, dude, las calles cerradas, pinches policías parked in the middle of the street. Dude, it's like the whole, like, there was like 3 police stations there. Worth of vehicles.
No shit.
And apparently, one of the schools was on lockdown because there was a shooter around.
Oh, man.
Ya eran las 7 de la noche, güey, and kids still in the classrooms.
Fuck.
The parents were outside. I'm like, what the fuck, esperando a sus niños? Pasé, no me quedé el chisme, güey. Nomás, I was just looking around like, oh, wait, fuck. Maybe we should have, you know, the Chicano show for microphone should be here, but... Yeah,
me está camisa around.
Está haciendo frío. So, me vine. And I started looking into it. While looking into it, I started finding all these stories around here. Un güey, it was a 4-year-old toddler. Mm. Fucking, they took her, I guess the paramedics picked her up and she died in the hospital. Mm. Pero que este güey era el papá and he beat her. Le metió de putazos and la encontraron unconscious.
But this is what the neighbors were saying?
No, this is the police report. The police report. That was one of them. The other one I was reading, un pinche, in downtown LA, un pinche homeless guy Fucking está, se ve en el video, güey.
Oh, yeah, I saw that one.
Está el homeless guy fucking va pasando a gente, he's ranting. You know, like, mm-hmm. la gente de whatever. En eso que este cabrón se para, he's like pacing back and forth. Nada que ver, güey. Pinche 60-year-old man pasando, pinche homeless guy lo empuja right in front of un pinche un semi, güey.
Oh, shit.
El pinche semi alcanza a frenar, but it does still cause damage.
Le pegó todo.
Le agarró todo el lado y le agarró el brazo. No le fucking rompe la cabeza porque pinche su angelito de guardia was looking out for him, güey.
Yeah, that was crazy, güey.
Like, fucking, hey, güey. Nada que ver.
Fuck.
Pinche señor just walking, fucking a lo mejor acaba de comprar su bagel, no sé qué, going back to work or going to work, and ¡fua! Te avientan en un pinche trailer encima de ti, güey.
You never know, bro.
Like, fuck. And then later on that same day, fucking firefighters saw him because the firefighters and the police que went to the... Ya con el señor, ya...
A buscarlo, güey.
No, ya fucking ayudarlo, lo mandaron al hospital. Later on, they had another call and they saw the guy... El pinche homeless guy, because he had a bright neon fucking...
Yeah, like a wrinkle, güey.
Yeah. Lo van viendo y que llaman a la placa, güey. Y yes. Simón es era.
Oh, shit.
Fucking, they're gonna lock him up y todo for attempted murder or no sé qué.
Well, yeah, basically.
Pero no está bien, güey. Ese güey no está bien, pero it's just like, fuck, dude. Well,
¿te acuerdas la morena que beat up that 92-year-old man también, güey?
Oh, yeah.
What happened to that, güey?
I think she got some time on that.
Ese güey también nada que ver, pobre don, güey. And then what, it's her word against his way. I heard a story the other day about a guy that saw a little kid kind of roaming in the park. And he was like, an older guy. And he was like, what the fuck? Why is this kid by himself? So he went to kind of like see, hey, where are your parents? Y que no sé qué. And eso que viene el papá todo amputado and accused the guy of trying to take the little girl mm-hmm. and abducting her. Mm-hmm. The guy was like, hey, no, I'm just, you know, she was lost.
Oh, shit.
Que le mete una pinche putiza, güey.
Oh, shit.
It didn't end their way. They put his face on Facebook. Que este güey is grabbing kids. Y que be careful.
Oh,
y el pobre viejito had to move the city, where he had to change all his fucking life because este güey thought que le estaba, he was abducting the kid. I mean, I get it. That mm-hmm. looks... You don't look in the right situation right there.
It doesn't. And who knows? A lo mejor, yeah.
Who knows, right?
Yeah. So it's like, you could say like, pobre señor, but at the same time, I'm like, hey, wait.
Like, si ves un niño perdido en el parque, would you go and see?
I wouldn't go by myself.
Está cabrón. Yeah, yeah. Nowadays,
I wouldn't go by myself. What I would do is like, if I see somebody else, I'm like, hey, excuse me, is that your child right there?
Yeah.
No, you know, because I've noticed that this kid's by themselves.
Yeah.
Like, do you know if they came with, no? Okay, well, can you keep an eye on while I ask around?
That's a little dangerous too, no?
But you have to get a female, because if you... recruit three vatos to figure out what the fuck.
Hey,
oh, this is a ring.
This is a
robachico ring.
Literally a robachico.
So you gotta be careful, bro. You gotta recruit them.
So it's gotten to the point where like, you can't.
Well, it's the same thing. Remember when people are fucking suing people for like saving their lives, way for giving them CPR and like breaking their ribs, and people and then people stop fucking.
Yeah.
And now restaurants too, I think they're not allowed. Like if you're choking, they're not allowed to like try to save you. They have to call the paramedics.
No, mames, man.
For the same thing, because people are suing like the restaurants because you broke my fucking rib, saving my life.
I know.
That's some culero shit.
That's some culero shit, man.
But yeah, with kids, está cabrón, güey. Eso está.
Yeah, with kids, you gotta be careful, man.
Yeah,
you gotta be careful.
In general, también.
I just remembered a story. I said, "No sean cabrona." So, so fucking my daughter fucking was playing fucking a t-ball or whatever, right?
Mm-hmm.
And one of the parents brought a. For after the game, they brought like ice cream and to make sundaes.
Oh,
like,
shit.
For all the kids.
Se pone el ambiente chingón, güey.
So,
where's the invite, güey?
Este güey fue una vez.
No más, güey. No más.
Yeah.
No, right?
Este güey fue una vez. Pero el pinche... El pinche... But they brought two of those big like tubs of ice cream. You know, those big fucking like...
Yeah, rectangle tubs.
So they didn't even get through the first one with all the kids we on the team.
Uh-huh.
And go, because those parents get them. We still got ice. All right, fucking... I took on my sundae. So el pinche mi compa, el coach... I just start trying to the other kids from the other team. He's like, he sees them with the other shirts. Yeah. He goes, hey, wait.
Dice aquí va a sobrar un chingo.
Yeah, ven, ven a agarrar pinche ice cream. We got a chingo of ice cream. So they're still serving up ice cream, güey.
Uh-huh.
Y todavía les está sobrando, because they're the two big ass tubs, güey.
Se la jalaron with the purchase.
At some point, el pinche compa, he's bringing like some kid. I see him, I go, hey, wait, this doesn't look right. He's bringing like some kid, and the kid looks all confused.
Yeah.
He's not wearing like a team uniform or anything, güey. He's like, yeah, aquí hay ice cream. Follow me. me. Follow me.
I know, mami.
And then the dad comes out of the nada, güey.
Oh,
like,
shit.
Hey, what's happening here? Yeah. Oh, no, we're just going to go get ice cream. And creo que es cuando se le prendió el foco.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, this sounds weird.
Yeah. We're going to get ice cream. Gotta be careful, man.
And the thing is, okay.
So then the dad and the kid, everybody.
I know the compa. I know his compa. But it's like, hay veces que no te la malicias porque no la estás haciendo con malicia, güey.
Yeah.
You just want to get the ice cream out before it melts.
Especially si el vato es inocente, he doesn't think like that, right?
Yeah. He was just trying to get everybody ice cream.
Yeah, he was being cool.
But it's cuando se le prendió. He's like, we're just going to go get ice cream. Yeah. But like, literally, like, if you look like down the line of sight, there's a mess out with people serving ice cream.
Yeah.
But look, because when I saw him coming, the kid was all confused, like, ice cream? Like, all right.
And going back to, porque no le invitamos, I don't think you want to step on there with his rape van, dude. Giving out ice cream from the van.
I got conos.
I got grab bags. Like, no chingues, güey.
Nah, man, I don't mess with that shit.
No, yeah.
That shit was fucking.
So, yeah, it's not, because come on, estamos diciendo, those times are past. They're gone.
Yeah.
Back in the days where, like, you know, you could rely on a stranger for help, and now you can't. You don't know. And not even that. The stranger maybe not even allow himself to help you.
Yeah.
You know?
People don't want to deal with that shit.
Yeah, fuck. Ay, a veces que, help me.
I know, right?
Yeah. Pues ya ves, like on the side of the freeways where people get stuck and they're not fucking before.
You just don't know.
As soon as someone like, oh shit, someone pull it out, you that way.
There's still some good people out there.
There's some.
Well, I read a whole little article on some dude, it was a while back, on some pinche güero, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And he fucking, I guess, it was before Trump, but he wasn't, I don't want to say racista, but in the thing, he forgot how he worded it, that he wasn't. He kind of saw like the fucking raza, like, hey, estos güeyes son malvientes, you know? They, I don't know, güey. Like, I'm not gonna.
They're bad hombres.
Yeah, they're bad hombres, pretty much. Pero de una vez, he goes, una vez, the whole article was about how fucking he pulled over one time, like, pulled over, like, his car broke down.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like in the middle of like between exits and like the walk that cabrón, but he doesn't even throw a fucking gas station. You know, it's like, que pedo. Y que fucking right away, while he's all fucking panicking, pinche vato in a minivan pulls over con toda la familia.
Oh,
fucking,
sure.
I don't know, van a la tienda, whatever, or a church, whatever. And yeah, some pinche paisa dude le empieza a ayudar. Oh, no, pues, no sabes. And they do that fucking weird thing where the dude doesn't know Spanish, el otro güey no sabe inglés, but somehow they communicate. Y el pinche vato lo sube al van con la familia.
Ay, güey.
Go get them gas. They stop for like fucking como Ramón, like to get the Jack in the Box, whatever. Shit. Fucking the kids, he's like, the kids, todo buena onda. Lo llevan al pinche carro y güey, que prende el carro. All right, your carro's good. All right, chido, güey. Pues gracias. Entonces el vato's like, hey, well, let me give you something for the fucking... For the fucking gas. Yeah.
I mean, cuando le metió la putiza because he got offended.
Fuck you. Oh, you mother bitch, son of a bitch.
You think I want something, cabrón? Le dio el pinche gancho al hígado.
Fuck your face, mother bitch.
le hizo the knife to the chest, como hizo este güey.
Pinche puñal.
¿Qué quieres de mí?
Puñal.
No, es Simón que le quiso a lana. He's like, no, güey, no.
Yeah.
No, and yeah, he went about on his way, and he's like, the whole article is about how fucking the whole thing changes his whole perspective.
Yeah, that's how it takes sometimes.
Because everybody's like, everybody's just passing by, and I'm like panicking because I don't know which, should I go this north, because should I go south? And no one fucking stopped except for this dude with his fucking whole family in the car, way.
Yeah.
Fucking.
Y como nada, súbete, güey.
Venían en el. Iban a ir a misa. A la
They have, which is that station? Which is that religious station, the AM, that all the fucking...
La Guadalupana?
No, ¿cuál es, güey? Fuck. Ah, whatever, güey. But there's one that I see in a lot of Astro vans and all the los que van a la iglesia, güey.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
En una estación de radio, güey.
Yeah. It's a religious one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pero sometimes that is, that's what it is, Fernando, is people don't have a conversation with these people that on the internet that says, fuck this fucking race or fuck these guys. Yeah. They're just here.
Or freaking
But it's people
illegals.
That are sheltered in their own community that they never dealt with a Mexican dude or a black
Central
guy or
American
whatever.
American or Asian or fucking Middle Eastern.
Because we feel the same about some fucking Mexicans, right? No mames. There's shitty people everywhere.
Yo no tengo confianza en los chilangos, güey.
Culero.
Siempre me guardo la cartera, culero.
Aguas con la cartera. Aguas con culero la cartera. Este,
güey. Chilangos, güey.
Oye, ¿qué te hice?
Calen tacos, quesadillas. ¿Qué chingadas son esas?
¿Quieres ir por unas quesadillas?
Hey, I love to the chilangos out there.
Traes lana en tu cartera.
Chinguen a su madre. No, no se crean.
Me gusta ese reloj que traes.
Oiga, amigo, ¿qué nos trae?
¿Cómo cae?
Cabrón, ¿qué le pasó a mi reloj?
Como cada quien tiene su way of talking,
güey. Pero dialects, güey. Están bien cantaditos los
güeyes. I had a tío de Michoacán que le decían el onzi. Porque así decía once.
Onzi.
Pues como a las onzi. Luego se le quedó. Se le quedó el onzi. Ahí viene el onzi. Y era bien pinche borracho el onzi, güey. El onzi. He was one of those fucking mans, güey. Pinche, güey. With his camiseta, the button up, kind of unbuttoned a little bit with his hairy chest, con las botitas.
Dude.
No, prima. Y le dice, es que primo, usted está así porque le gusta así.
O sea que está ancho porque
le gusta. Le gusta, pero le hacía así con la manita, güey.
Como un taquito. O como vente para la boca.
Yeah, así, güey. Yeah. Ese onzi tiene pinche hueso.
Fuck, los pinches apodos. Gay. I remember my parents, well, los amigos y familia y todo. Había uno que le hicieron el Cuaresma.
¿El Cuaresma?
El Cuaresma.
Ah, cabrón, ¿por qué?
Porque era alto y flaco, o sea, era largo y sin carne, güey.
Oh, God.
Le hicieron el Cuaresma.
El Cuaresma.
I used to fucking admire this man's fucking brocha, dude, this fucking mustache. Le hicieron el Tatalish. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was from the family que tenemos en Santana, güey. Mm-hmm. He was cross-eyed, mm-hmm. right? Pero pinche esos vaqueros, like, si lo ves, si él saliera en Narcos, güey, yeah. Parecía pinche asesino, güey.
¿A poco sí, güey?
But he was the nicest guy, the most lovable, fucking cheerful guy.
But he had that look.
He had that look, pero pinche bigote chingón, güey.
Oh, shit.
Firme, güey.
Nice.
Y pero distract from the eyes, güey.
Fucking cross-eyed.
I know, it was a distraction for the eyes,
yeah. So, like, fuck, y le hicieron el Tatalish. I never knew why.
Tatalish.
I don't know.
El Tatalish.
I don't know, güey.
But I'm sure que el Porvisco has something to do with it, no?
I guess.
It's a reference to that.
Yo creí el casi ve, ¿no? El Tatalish. No sé. Mm. But I don't know what happened to him. I gotta ask the family a ver cómo está.
Yeah, like, some of them. My dad and him que le decían los resortes. Like, what? No sé, güey. Resorte. But isn't that a shock también? It's like a shock.
Well, that's resorte. That's a
no, pero este güey le hizo como resortera.
Yeah, resortera.
Yeah, no.
Oh, un resorte también es a shock.
I don't know, güey. ¿Por qué decían el resorte?
El amortiguador.
Yeah, because I got a tío que le dicen poca luz.
¿Poca luz?
Because he squints. He has a squint.
Poca luz.
El poca luz.
Ay, güey.
Oh, my God. There's like, there's so many fucking relatives that got fucking...
I mean,
farm animals.
Yeah. Oh, no. I used to have an uncle que straight out of my tío gordo. It was straight out.
El tío gordo.
Yeah, tío gordo.
There's no creativity.
As an adult, I mean, you know what? The fucked up part that he died way like at, he was almost fucking 500 plus pounds.
Oh,
way.
Shit.
Pero as a kid, uno no sabe, güey. Hey, tío gordo. Tío gordo. And then as an adult, you're like, what the fuck?
I'm calling him gordo. So
yeah.
Fucking, we had friends, or my dad had friends que decían la chiva.
Yeah, la chiva.
Mi dad le decían, ¿cómo le decían? Oh my God, my dad had so many names, dude.
A mi onco siempre se. He had like one of those. Le pegaban los calambres, güey.
Oh God.
We would be sitting in like Thanksgiving and de repente start shaking. Y luego, por eso le pusieron el ay ay ay. Casi, güey, por ay ay ay.
Ay ay ay. Oh.
Y se llamaba la yayay, güey.
A mi dad le decían el palomillo.
¿Por qué, güey?
I have no idea.
No, pues.
El palo... I gotta ask him. Oiga, don Chano. ¿Por qué le decían el palomillo?
Those are stories que no te dice, güey.
Yeah, maybe it's got something to do with fucking... Fucking... ¿Se le salió la paloma o qué? I don't know.
That's part of a good story behind that name, güey. You got work this week, güey. Ramon's going on site. Reporting,
a ver,
on
don
site.
Chano. I should record him.
That would be cool, man.
Ay, para...
Te están robando la ven, güey. La pinche troca.
Oh, shit.
Ah, cabrón.
So, ya no, que trataras con tu pinche no rap, güey.
¿No se prendió el pinche teléfono?
Oh, yeah, well, no. It's because, we got a...
You read it, güey. Tienes la voz más chingona. Luego te enojas because I don't tell the stories of your specs. Y te enojas. So you tell
your specs.
We have a, is it douchey?
We have an SSDUSHU service because I'm like, what the fuck is going out there? All right, so este vino de Mr. Pogstatic. Or What is it? Yeah, Pogstatic or whatever. Pogtastic. There we go. Se encabrona cuando le digo Pogstatic. But it's Pogtastic. I know. So he's like, hey, I les doy un, is it douchey? So, I was asking you here, read it. I gotta go check that out. Come on. I'll have Esteban read it.
Let what me happened, bro?
I gotta go check it out. I gotta go check out what's going on.
Nothing's going on, man. Check it out. Fuck that. Let's talk about something. He's gonna read this shit.
No, no, pues, pero no, no, Harley.
I know, right? He can't have neighbors that have cars that they turn on and le falta catalytic converter and they're kind of loud.
Le hizo un hoyo para que haga más ruido.
Luego, luego, yeah. He's got that K&N filter. Le quitó todo el pinche housing for the filter.
Well, you know, the paisa move was drilling the hallway para que haga más
ruido. Yeah. Che Ramon, he can't have the neighbors turning their car on.
Me están robando my fucking.
Oh,
is this what I said? You can't warm up a Harley, way? Yeah, porque pinche Ramon.
Ah, cabrón, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
That's how I was doing it. All right, so we're back to this. So, Mr. Pogstatic or Pogtastic, whatever. So, ahí les da una, is it douchey? So, when I was a young soldier stationed in Fort Polk, Louisiana, my battalion was in the field training. Of course, with my luck, I had 0000 to 400. Well, he breaks it down in military time.
Oh, military time?
Yeah. So, desde las 12 a las 4.
No. Yeah, I don't know that time. Sometimes it's like, what the fuck? 12. 12 is like the baseline, no?
Yeah.
Las 12.
Las 12, la madrugada. La madrugada, güey.
Yeah. De 12 a 4, güey.
Yeah.
Cuando se pone lo bueno, güey.
Yeah.
Güey, 12 es mediodía, güey.
No, 12 en la noche.
Midnight. And then 24 hours,
mamá. Medianoche. Oh, yeah.
It would be 24, yeah.
Yeah. So this is midnight to 4 in the morning. Yeah. All right. But he put the...
graveyard.
00.
Yeah, 100 hours to 400 hours.
What's the latitude and longitude on that? What's the coordinates?
I don't know that. So he had from midnight to 4, those hours at the tower guard duty. That's midnight to 4. He broke it down for civilian time, for civilian vatos.
Para los pendejos de Chicano Shuffle.
Para los pendejos y todos civilian
they're
going to
argue about it anyways. If you broke it down, it was
from midnight to 4. Our cooks were there all day, usually had some really shitty hours. They got up at 4 in the morning and slept around 1 in the morning. And he remembers that one of the cooks, sergeant, was Puerto Rican vato. He was cleaning up around midnight, like 12:30 in the morning. He went to sleep right after. The battalion commander, who was a lieutenant colonel, probably doing administrative shit, made one of his flunkies wake up the cook so that he could get coffee around 2 a.m. Naturally, they were pissed since they only got very limited sleep. So did the rest of the guys, but that's otro pedo. So the sergeant makes the coffee, and like an hour later, I see the battalion commander and sergeant major go hauling ass to the porta shitters. All right. Later on that day, I talked to the sergeant in Spanish, which I guess is a cook. Mm-hmm. Y le pregunté, hey, sargento, that must have been some shitty coffee. He's all like, no, coño. I made sure that to wash the... I made sure not to wash the dish soap off the coffee pot so that they could get the runs. Fucking with him and his guys. So what happened is que no lavó la pinche olla.
Le dejó el jabón.
Le dejó el jabón. And... So the question is...
He didn't rinse it.
Yeah. So the question is it douchey?
Que no le lavó para que les pegara chorro?
Que les pegara chorro los cabrones.
Because they were fucking with them, no?
Yeah.
Well, they woke his ass late.
Yeah.
Estaba durmiendo el culero.
I mean, how hard is it to make coffee, güey? Yeah. Why do you have to wake up the main cook?
You know what? Coffee... shout out to Los Pipiripaos for that video.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
I learned something in that video, güey. I've had it wrong my whole life, güey. Esos cabrones usan agua del garrafón para el café, güey.
Yeah.
Yo le pongo del pinche sink.
The tap.
Because the heat's going to kill the germs. Pero estos cabrones le ponen el garrafón, güey.
No, muchas gracias a Rolando y Heriberto. They really did us a fucking solid with that, dude.
That was an awesome video.
They didn't have to do it.
Yeah.
They didn't have to do that little promo. I don't know. It's just, it was really.
It was out of the blue is what he's trying to say, güey. Like no one asked them and it just happened. So whatever. Thanks.
Pero si te levantan así a la medianoche, güey, para hacer café, güey.
I mean, fuck that, dude. I would be pissed.
Yeah.
You'll leave the jabón in the thing.
Yeah.
Le fucking lo bato con el pinche.
Le echas un charquito. Le echas un churrito.
Tunk. You know? No, no, es que no mamen, güey. I mean, how hard is it to make coffee? And then I could understand si los están despertando a las 2 de la mañana because quieren un breakfast.
Yeah, but isn't it part of like the hazing or whatever they call it? It's like the...
Yeah, but this dude's not a newbie, güey.
He's a fucking sergeant.
A sargento, pero maybe it was one of those names. También le decían al sargento, nobody knew why. So I don't know his ranking, güey. That's his street ranking, el sargento.
Street ranking.
Fucking, I don't know why they call him sargento. Yeah. Pues esa madre es one of those positions que se presta, like the military se presta to be a little extra, ¿no? Sometimes.
Yeah.
With people that are under your rank or some shit. Like los quieres pinches. What would you do if you were in that position and you needed somebody to make you coffee? You would make it yourself?
I think I would.
Yeah?
I would.
But then people say you're soft because you're not fucking...
No, because a good leader knows that his team needs rest.
Hey, cabrón, por eso es una pinche eminencia este güey.
That's why his name is underlined.
Yeah, that's why you make the big bucks here at Chicano Shuffle.
I don't make shit.
Our pay grade is a little under.
That's why they recognize Ramon on the streets.
No, oh, yeah. It's you know, like I want my team to be well rested. I want my team to que duerman y todo. Si yo tengo ganas de café, sabes qué, pues ya cerraron la cocina. Well, fuck it, I can figure my way out in the fucking kitchen.
Yeah, you have to lead by example.
Yeah,
in that point, right?
Yeah. So why am I gonna wake up the guys para un pinche pot of coffee?
Yeah.
No, I'm like, okay, look.
Yeah, it's not like he's cooking up an omelet. Wait.
No, I'm like, I just need a pan. Ahí está el agua. I know how to.
He'll probably ask for a fucking omelet. Says it,
no, pues tampoco.
Hey, so why are you in the kitchen making coffee for me? Hey, tráele unos huevitos ahí, ¿no?
I see you make some chingón fucking cinnamon rolls. Ponle
también, ¿no?
Some chingón cinnamon rolls.
Yeah, you still got a pancake batter?
Yeah.
You still got a waffle iron back there.
Yeah, you know. Fucking, no? Yeah, so I think it's not douchey.
You're not douchey?
You don't think it's douchey? No, I don't think it's douchey. Look, you see, I don't know.
To wake up people while
they're... No.
The douchey is que les dio chorro a los otros.
Oh, yeah,
I don't think it's douchey. Fuck that.
I saw they had it coming, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, what do you expect? Fucking being an asshole and not fucking get the runs? Ni madres, way.
But then, if you look at it from a little perspective, way, si un pinche vato en tu cheeseburger le echa el pinche...
But
you're paying for
that.
Were you being a dick?
But you're paying for the service at that point.
Yeah,
you're paying para que they keep cold and all that shit.
That's true. I take it back. It's rescinded.
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't want anybody. You got to think, there's people spit on our shit in our life at least a few times, right?
Cabrón, what was it?
La sabor.
El otro día fui a 7-Eleven, güey. Ahí fue a comprar, ¿qué compré?
Do you like your hot dog?
No. Oh, I bought like a...
Okay.
Un pinche...
Okay,
one of those hot pockets.
Mm.
Compré un
the
hot
pepperoni, okay?
Yeah, the pepperoni.
So we've established classic. You don't need to be high to eat hot pockets.
No, I know you don't.
Classic,
way. Yeah, so lo compré. And the thing is, I'm walking up to the counter y veo que el cabrón se está picando la pinche nariz, güey.
Ah, no mames.
Se le está picando. And I'm like, I look at him. And como que me ve and then se agacha. But there was a, like, como I'm walking up and then this lady snakes me. For that. And then so she asked for fucking some pizza or whatever. And I'm like... ¿Se va a poner este güey guantes o qué?
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, y no se puso guantes, but the thing is that he used the tongs. But I'm like, yeah, dude, I don't think you want to be scratching your nose and the fucking...
But that's only what you saw, where...
Yeah.
What else has he
How
done?
How deep did he go?
I know. You know?
When you think about it, where...
Yeah, no, maybe cuando metió la pizza, la agarró con la mano, güey.
Yeah. No. Pero no hay pedo que el taquero no usa guantes, right?
No, sí. Ya he estado viendo que los taqueros are starting to use gloves.
Yeah.
It's because the güeros have discovered tacos, güey.
I know, seriously.
Hablando de tacos, I got
the only ones that worry about that, güey.
Yeah, they pinch, you know?
Yeah, güey.
Yeah,
estos guantes me hacen lento.
Yeah.
I got a Korean coworker. Uh-huh. No mames, güey. Este cabrón knows about his tacos, eh?
Really?
He knows, like, he was telling me all the spots in, like, MacArthur Park and K-Town.
Uh-huh.
Oh, dude, you gotta go try out this taco truck.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you gotta go this one, but this is during the day. Uh-huh. They got really good. Over here, you gotta go at night. Una que sí me llamó la atención es a Sinaloa Taco Truck.
Mm-hmm. Why?
It's 8th and Ardmore. Mm-hmm. I was looking at the reviews, and a lot of people like, fuck yeah, dude. And I'm like...
Yeah? ¿Son diferentes los de Sinaloa o qué?
No sé, trying to find out.
Se llama La Lonchera, ¿no?
Yeah, sí se llama La Lonchera. Sinaloa Truck.
Crazy, güey.
Yeah. Pero no, güey. It's... It's not douchey.
No?
You? Nah, they had it coming, way.
Yeah. Nah, fuck that.
So, the consensus is...
lo levantaron.
It's not douchey.
Vergas.
Yeah.
Expect some fucking revenge.
That's the... que le dicen al sargento on the street somewhere, he's the MVP this week.
El sargento on the street.
El sargento.
All right. Otra cosa. Before we...
oh. Dale.
We have one of our Patreon sponsors...
our Patreon sponsors?
One of our Patreon supporters.
Sorry. Oh, okay.
Was she sent out letting us know that her sister had passed away.
Mm.
Right? And she has a GoFundMe right now to help out. So I know I have the information here. Como yo no
sé. No, no está preparado.
No, sí la tenía. I had it bookmarked, but se me pasó.
Oh, pues.
I know. I had to go back to the is it douchey fucking...
So it's the fans' fault that threw him off. Ramon always blaming people. No, que leader, que no sé qué. I was talking a few fucking breaths ago. Que I'll be the leader.
Throwing wisdom.
Que. Now he throws people under the bus.
I don't go. I don't put people under the bus. So this is for one of the supporters of Elia. Her sister passed away. So if you guys can help out, go to the GoFundMe page and put in. It's I guess for Alma Hernandez.
Yeah,
it's Alma Hernandez, right? And they're trying to they need more people to help out. They've had like 65 people helping in like 19 days, so you know we'll try to do a little part también. But like wanted to see if our fans could reach out and maybe help out the Hernandez family. It's for Alma Hernandez, and let me see. Does it need anything else for me?
I don't know. It's on Facebook, and we'll put it on.
Oh, yeah.
Find a way to put it on Instagram, yeah. Too, Wayne.
It's on Facebook. So, ahí pa' que, si, you know, especially around this time, I know it's tough. It's in the holidays, and I know that Freddie was telling us that our supporter told us, told us that it was during the Thanksgiving weekend. So
yeah, man.
They couldn't...
Right around the time.
Yeah, so instead of them being with family, I mean, they were with family, but in different circumstances.
Yeah.
You know, so if you guys could reach out, you know, help out, you know, another fan, another supporter of the Chicano Shuffle podcast, you know, greatly appreciate it. And that's all I got.
It was good.
Get the thing. Guitar.
Fucking gotta wrap it up quickly.
No me grites, güey.
Not the way. Este vez el Ramón apunta media libreta.
And just so that you guys know, if you guys are around town in December, the 15th, our good friend Momo is going to be having a show at the Ice House. I think he wants to make it a posada. He wants to make it a posada, like, you know, with chocolate and freaking conchitas y buñuelos.
Oh, shit. Might be good, way.
Shufflers, it's that time of the podcast where we get to do our little reshuffle. Gentlemen, it's 2018. Let's hop on around the house, you know? Ya no son los tiempos de antes. Todos podemos. What we also found out in this episode is that it's tough dating a musician, you know? You're not forced, you're not asked, you're not expected. But, you know, you end up lugging an 8-pound guitar. So, fucking...
It's 2018, we're equal here.
All right. Another thing we realize is that critics are fucking brutal. You know? Greta Van Fleet is a pretty good band. If you guys have a chance, go check them out. Otra cosa que nos dimos cuenta, Esteban likes to do a lot of shopping and thrift shops and everything, and we just realized, fucking, cuidado, your phone is always listening, because they know what kind of sweater you just bought, and you never, ever talked about it before that. Let me see. Animalitos. Let's take care of them. You know, they care for us. Let's take care of them. Don't be dicks. Don't be hurting them. Don't be beating them or tying them down or fucking maltratándolos. All they want is to love you and to be loved. And maybe fed.
Unless they're cats and they don't care about you, eh? No. But tampoco no los maltraten.
And now, the other thing that we started looking around is that I guess they're trying to manifest vegan options, or they're trying to push the vegan options mandate.
Yeah, they're trying to fucking make restaurants.
Yeah. The other thing we found out in this episode is that Ramon is not smooth at all. La cago.
I'm a smooth operator.
I'm not a smooth operator, man.
I don't know about talking in third person. I've always had an issue with people that talk in third person.
So I just say, okay, I'm not a smooth operator.
That's pretty douchey way, in my opinion, way. Deucey.
He's reached the level where he talks about himself in third person.
You didn't hear him say?
Yeah,
he came to the consensus at Ramon.
I didn't come to no consensus. Ramon came up to a consensus on Ramon.
All right, well, we did come into this right? This consensus.
Because no one said.
Sofia Vergara sí es guapa.
Está guapa.
Está guapa.
Está guapona.
Yeah.
Digo no. Digo. Digo no.
The other thing we found out, Esteban, is like, bastard does not equal mal parido.
Not equivalent.
No. And the other thing we were wondering, like, what happened to the fun dip?
What happened to
it? Pinche fun dip, yeah.
What happened to it? Y luego, ¿qué onda es pinche Walmart? No chinguen. You know,
todos que paran.
Todo lo que se ahorran en lo que no le pagan a los pinches associates, fucking no lo ponen en la construcción, güey.
No.
What the fuck? The other thing we found out is that Cali people are spoiled.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, güey. Fucking baja 74 degrees and we're like, ya sacamos la bufanda, the jackets, the gloves.
74, 64.
I don't know, dude. Fucking it gets below 70 something and yeah, fucking estamos todos con fríos, güey.
Estamos prendiendo los calentones, güey. Yeah.
That's true.
A San Marcos comes out.
Another one. Raza, if you like to fucking smoke the devil's lettuce or chest un frajo or whatever, don't expose people to your vices. You know, be considerate. Una caminadita, pues, ¿sabes qué? Pues, yeah, not everybody smokes. Not everybody fucking le gusta el olor de mota o el de cigarro o el de pipa o el de puro. You know, just take a little walk. It might help you. Now, for all your conspiracy theories, go to donchano.com. Ese güey tiene todo.
I don't know if all conspiracy theories.
Man. I don't know, man.
He was right about a few things.
I'm gonna ask him about the Michael Jackson theory. A ver qué dice.
A ver qué dice.
A ver qué dice Don Chano de Miguelito Jackson.
Miguelito.
You know. Otra cosa. Los nada que ver. Pobres, güey. That was fucked up, dude. Sí me dio lástima ese 60-year nada que ver, güey.
Yeah.
That was jacked up.
No, está cabrón, güey.
I put down. So nowadays, I was in being a good Samaritan because it's not what it used to be, güey. Fucking, yeah. Te van a agarrar a putazos. They're gonna put your picture up. You're gonna have to move city. Y todo because you know what? Pinche chiquillo estaba solo. You know, so I was with being a good Samaritan. Otra cosa, raza, shufflers, pochos, chicanos, whatever you want to call yourself, paisas. We all grew up with friends of the family or tíos or tías or primos con pinches apodos, güey. El Onzi.
El Onzi.
Es un buen ejemplo. I'm sure you guys have them. If you do, send us the nicknames and why.
Yeah, why?
Yeah, why? Yeah. Why? ¿Por qué le decían el pinche?
Yeah, don't be like Ramon. Throw out the name. They're not explaining it, güey.
¿Por qué le decían el clamato?
El clamato. El ostión. Tío, ¿por qué le dicen el ostión?
Tío, ¿por qué le dicen el pulpo y le hacen así? Como que tiene 10 manos.
Tío, ¿por qué le dicen al incapaz?
El incapaz.
Ay, güey.
All right, so send us those. Those will be fun.
Oh, shit.
And... It was a unanimous vote that the little is it douchey que nos mandó Pog Static, and I know your name is not Pog Static, it's Pugnat, but whatever. Pog Static. Pognastic. Es un pinche trabalenguas, ese pinche nombre, güey.
Pogonator.
Yeah, el pinche el Pog. All right, it's not douchey, güey. That fucker deserved it. Pinche chorro, bien merecido, güey.
Pobre es el que tiene que limpiar los baños, though.
Yeah. I just want to thank our you know, we just want to thank supporters and fans and everything. I want to thank David John, Evelyn Angel, El Lorenzo, Fabian. I want to thank Sulu Mike for sending us that Juan Gabriel fucking conspiracy. I want to thank también este Brown Jedi Master for enjoying the Spotify. I think we're working on it. I said that we're going to have another one.
Ramon's Spotify.
No. And like I said, next week we're having, well, not next week, but in the following weeks, if you're down here in LA, va a estar el Momo in the Ice House, December 15th at 10. And then on the 16th, va a estar el Molcajete Dominguero, right there at 501 Main. So you guys want to go check them out. Check out Los Compas de Pipiripao. Thank you very much, Rolando and Heriberto. You guys fucking killed it, dude. Killed it, man. You didn't have to, but thank you.
Yeah.
Raza, check out at official Pipiripao or Pipiripao.
Pipiripao.com.
.com. Alright. Check out the shirts, check out the posters, check out the gear. Está chingón.
Camisas chidas.
And these guys are like the most humblest, hardworking, fucking firme vatos I've met, you know? We all agree. Estos cabrones están chingones. Alright, and with that, I'd like to say thank you, and Esteban, take us out, man.
Como chinga.
Ay, güey.